Let your healing come in this place. I call for signs and wonders in this place. Let your presence flow in this place. Anointing follow me. Your mercies will I see. Mama Joy, good evening. Thank you for joining. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Thank you for joining, Mama. Ooh, yes, you never change. Ooh. God bless every one of you for joining. I really do appreciate you. God bless you. Oh, yeah, Mama. Yes, so I can see that you enjoy your day. Thank you for joining. My minister, Minister Becky, when I see what you cause. You see what I tell Richard, so? My minister, Minister Becky, God bless you for joining. Amen. And you too, Mama. And you too. May the Almighty God continue to strengthen us for His work. We will not faint in the name of Jesus. Thank you for joining. Yes, you never change. Anointing follow me. Your mercy will I seek. Oh, just like the days when powers by the sea, your power remains the same. Yes, it never changed. My evangelist in the house, Evangelist Joyce, Mama, God bless you for connecting. God bless every one of you. Mama Eve, Obas, Mama Mary, Yahweh, God bless you. Our time will not always permit me to mention all your names. As you all can see that I am starting even so late today. All the same, it is well. Like I'm just telling my minister, and not quite long, we close from our own Bible study in church. So I'm just coming back from church. From my Bible study and digging deep, that is why you see me this time. Like I said, though, I don't really do the video because I'm looking for a lot of viewers, but I'm just here to fulfill what my Heavenly Father have asked me to do. So God bless you. For as many that are online now, thank you for joining. Let's just worship God with this song. Let His power flow. Amen. Hey, you alone, my God. Fi agbara re wa, fi agbara re wa, fi agbara re wa. Oh, oh, yama, yelele, oh, yelele ya, oh, you want in my signs I wonder, yelele ya. I'm so excited. David says, oh yeah, Alpha, thank you. I'm so excited. Even till I even get to the house, I was still on phone. Oh yeah, thank you for joining. Oh yeah, let's come and preach it together now. She was on my neck till I get to the house. She was on my neck. You can see that I'm obeying now. I'm obeying. Oh yeah, am I not obedient? I am obeying. She said the matter never finished. Minister Becky, oh yeah, say. She said that matter never finish. On Wednesday, I'm bringing it back again. We will finish it. In fact, I will not rest my case. So you can see that I am obeying now, Ovia, right? So actually, you know that there are some topic when it comes up like that in church. In fact, everybody will want to talk. Like tonight, we were like, it was very interesting in our Bible study. Like we were talking about this book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, when Apostle Paul was talking about that we should cover that the woman, she's giving me thumbs up. She said she will not rest. When Apostle Paul was like talking about air and head. So that was, it was really an exciting topic in the church. And you know, whenever that topic come up like that, so I don't know if really there is anybody in the house, like what is that Bible scripture really talking about? So that is what everybody was just trying to bring up, their different suggestion, that if really a woman supposed to cover her hair or her head and her hair, or already if the hair has already covered the head. Uh-huh. That was the bone of contention in our Bible study this evening. And actually a lot of and especially when it now comes to the extent of they said the women should keep quiet in the church, the women should not see anything in church. Oh my goodness, it was really exciting. Look at the time, I'm already coming up, but I really want to say, Father, to you, to him alone deserves all the glory and all the praise. So anyhow it goes, may the name of the Lord be glorified. So I really want to say God bless as many of you that are still online, even at this time. God bless you all. So I still want to worship God before I commence. No man can see the end of your grace. Ah, no man can see the end of your love. Ah, no man can see the end of your glory. No man can see the end of your love. Join me to say, as far as the heavens stand, stand above the earth, you are exalted, unlimited God. As far as the heavens stand, stand above the earth, you are exalted, unlimited God. Oh, you are exalted, you are exalted, you are exalted, yeah. Unlimited God, you are exalted, you are exalted, you are exalted, unlimited God. As far as the heavens stand, Lord, stand above the earth, you are exalted, unlimited God. As far as the heavens stand, stand above the earth, you are exalted, unlimited God. Oh, you are exalted, you are exalted, you are exalted, unlimited God. Beloved, just join me and let's appreciate God for making it possible for us to come together again in this platform, this wonderful Wednesday. Let's just give God all the praise. Like I keep telling us, the word of God is here and amen. Yes, it is because of his grace that I am able to, in fact, I finished from Bible study and dig it deep. It's because of his grace that I can still even come here to say, oh, I still want to talk about my Father which is in heaven. I really want to say, just join me and let's appreciate God, because the Bible says by strength, no man can prevail. Like we keep saying that sometimes the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. But we cannot really go over it or stand against it, because it is what God has asked us to do. And the message tonight, I want to be talking about what it takes to become an ambassador of Christ. What does it take for you to become an ambassador of Christ? And I want to let us know, first of all, I will define the meaning of ambassador for us, but just join me to appreciate God for this grace, for this grace. It's grace, for this grace, for this grace. Like I keep on saying, to serve is a, how will I put it? It's a privilege, it's a privilege. I don't boast about it. What do I know? Without Jesus, there is no me. Without Jesus, there is no me. So just join me to give him all the praise, to say thank you, Lord, for giving us the grace to be able to come together again like this. Even for those that are online now, and I know that even after today, a lot will still watch it because the time has fast spent. So I just wanted to join me to appreciate the grace of God. I don't take it for granted at all. I don't take it for granted. Yes, Lord, without you, there is no me. Without you, there is no me. Father, I appreciate you for this grace and the privilege to serve. Father, I'm just like a servant before you. Father, in the process of serving, I render myself, oh God, as a servant before you. Yes, indeed, you call me your friend. But Lord, you said in your word, if only we can hearken and diligently obey your word, then we will be proud to become your own. We'll be proud to become your friends. I humble myself, oh God, as a servant before you now. Father, use me, Lord. I have no words of of my own. Holy Spirit of the Most High, come and teach us once again your word. Give us the grace and the ability to know what it takes to become ambassadors for you, even in this land, in our journey, in our pilgrim, oh God. Father, give us the grace, oh God, to continue to serve you, that we will not faint, oh God, by the wayside. No matter what the world is trying to tell us, no matter what the situation might be, no matter the trials, the temptations, the persecutions, give us the grace to stand. Give me grace to follow, abundant grace to follow you. I need your grace to follow. Your grace is enough for me. I need your grace, your grace. Give me grace to follow. Your grace is enough for me. Yes, Lord, your grace indeed is enough for me. I just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I hand over this platform unto your able hands. Glorify your name. It's not all about me. Father, it's all about you. Jesus, it's just all about you. Glorify your name once again tonight. And Lord, I ask, oh God, that by your own self, do what only you can do. I decrease now that you might increase in me. Spirit of the Most High, teach us once again tonight. Father, I ask, oh God, for better interpretation of your message to your people tonight. Holy Spirit of God, you alone can do this for me. Father, whatever, oh God, that is not of you that is in this platform right now, I raise a standard against it in the mighty name of Jesus. I soak this platform with the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover this platform with the blood of Jesus. Whatever that is not of you, I command it to give way. Every spirit of misinterpretation, I raise a standard against you tonight in the name above every other name. Yes, Lord, by your own self, do what only you can do. I hand over now. Take the lead while I follow. I declare this meeting open tonight in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you all once again. For as many that are online, time is not somebody's friend. So like I said, I'm just coming back from church. I still say, well, let me just go online. And I pray that God will help me. Whether good or bad, the word of God, it is settled and it is settled. So like I said, I want to be talking about what it takes to become an ambassador of Christ. Do you actually know, like a lot of us, we are failing our duty today. Many of us, we are failing this duty. Like I keep telling people, whether we like it or not, you and I, we are here for a mission. We are in the world for a mission. You and God have, in fact, we are in this earth for a mission. So you have been chosen as an ambassador of Christ. And a lot of us today, we are failing. A lot of us are really failing our duty. And our duty post, we are failing. Now, what it takes to become an ambassador of Christ, what does it take? I will want to define ambassador for us before I'll be reading some Bible scriptures for us. Now, who is an ambassador? Mama Susanna, God bless you for joining. Maybe she has been waiting. I know a lot of people might be saying, oh, is she not coming on live today? Like I said, even if I am here with for one person, may the name of the Lord be glorified. It's not how far, but it's how where. It's not how many people that share the video. It's not how many people that listen to the message. It's not how many viewers that watch the video, but it's all about how many that we put to practice. That is what they have heard. That is what the kingdom of heaven is all about. It's not all about 15,000 or whatsoever, 1,000 comments, 1,000 same whatsoever. I'm not here for multitude, but I'm here that God will always single out that one man, that one woman, that one boy, that one girl, for them to be able to reconcile back to him. A lot of people are in Christ Jesus. They claim that they are in Christ Jesus, but they are no longer in Christ Jesus. A lot of people claim that they know Jesus, but they don't really know him. A lot of people find some of them are still in the world, why some of them are still evil inside the church, because it's not everybody that is inside the house of God that really know God. Like that is why the Bible says, in a great house there shall be vessels of honor still inside that great house, which is the building, which is the church. Now we are talking about the building, we are talking about the church. The Bible also says still inside that great house there are still going to be vessels of dishonor. Still inside the church there will be vessels of gold. Some are of earth, and some are of wood. So all are still in the great house. So like I am saying, I'm not here because I want a lot of viewers or I want to make name, but I am here because I want to make name for my Father, which is in heaven. That is why he sent me as a representative to this earth. I am an ambassador on this earth. So also you. So a lot of us, we are failed to realize this, that we are on a duty. We are in a duty post for the Lord. So when it comes to service, when it comes to serving, you are a servant to God. When it comes to service, you know, even Jesus humbled himself. He humbled himself and he served in order for his name today to be exalted above every other name. So when it comes to duty posts, we have different areas where we become servants in order for us to be able, because we become servants in order for us to be able to serve other people. That is where the humility comes in. Because the Bible says, blessed are the meek. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the meek. So, we are talking about humility, humbleness. So, like I said, who is an ambassador? An ambassador is someone representing his country in a distant land. An ambassador is someone representing his or her country in a distant land. They play the essential role of representing nations, the interests of their nations. Let me switch off this internet so that calls will not disturb my phone. Yeah, let me off the net. So like I said, an ambassador is that person that is representing his or her country in a distant land. Now, they have very essential role, essential duty to play in that nation. Now, as Christians, we have an even greater honor than ordinary ambassador. We have the if you are from Italy, now the Italians, they have their own embassy, and there is somebody that is representing, standing as an ambassador in that Italian embassy. Now, when you talk about Spain, they have their own embassy. Nigeria, like our country, Nigeria, we have our own ambassador. In every country, we have our own representative as an ambassador. And now, they are representing our country. Like here where I am, we have a Nigerian embassy right here where we do go to. If for instance, maybe you want to seek for your visa or you want to get your passport. So we have Nigeria embassy in every country. And now these ambassadors, they send them all the way from Nigeria to Europe, two of us, to represent our country. Now, they are maybe an ambassador of Nigeria in Spain, for instance. If you go to the Nigeria embassy right now in Spain, there is an ambassador there. But when you get there, you will still see the picture of President Buhari. Buhari now standing as the president in Nigeria. Now, he sent somebody to represent the country in Spain, right? But whether the ambassador leave Nigeria and come to Spain. The ambassador now, even when he is in Spain, is in Europe, is he a Spanish man? Capital letter, no. Spain is not his country. Nigeria, they sent him all the way from Nigeria to Spain. So whether good or bad, one day, maybe he will still pack his load and go back to where he comes from. Why? Because anytime, if he does well, maybe he will continue to be in that office. But his work will not even tell if he will spend a lot of time in that seat or not. This is how I love bringing physical things to spiritual things. This is how we are. This is how we are in when it comes to the kingdom business. You and I, we are a representative of God. So now I want us to see something. If we can honor the Nigeria embassy or any of the Nigeria embassy ambassador in our various countries, now the honor you and I we have as the children of God is even far, far, far more greater than that honor that we normally use to honor all those Nigeria ambassadors in each of the embassies we have in our various countries. That is why I said, as Christians, as children of the Most High God, we have even greater honor, because why? We are ambassadors of Christ, representative of the Lord Jesus Christ here on earth. We are representing the great King and the kingdom known to mankind here on earth. Now, I want us to see the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. Ephesians 6, 19 to 20, and 2 Corinthians 5, verse 20 to 21. Like I said, my platform is for people that really want to, they want to get things done with the Lord. Because why? I keep telling us, The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. The laborers are few. And as an ambassador of Christ and his kingdom here on earth, you are here because an ambassador, there is something you must know before you go and represent. You want to represent your country. You cannot just go there to say, oh, I'm an ambassador of Nigeria. Buhari just sent me all the way from Nigeria to Spain. There is something that he has asked you to go and do there, that he has asked that man to go and do in that office. There is an instruction that... And maybe the president, or let me use Nigeria as a case study here. There is an instruction that Buhari has given to that Nigeria embassy to go and do there. And if he disobey, he face, before you know, he will see himself out of that place. He will see himself out of that seat, out of the place. And before you know it, another person will take over. Another person will take over. So what am I trying to say? So let's see the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. I want to be letting us know that what it actually takes for us to be Christ ambassador. It's not just I am a Christian like a lot of us used to say. So like I said, there are a lot of people that even claim that they know this Jesus, but they are still very far. And that is the worst thing that can ever happen to a man. There is a far difference between you or me that say we have already known God. There is a big difference between you and me that say we have already accepted Jesus as a Lord and a personal Savior. With those that are not evil, the worst thing that can ever happen to a man is when a man will say, oh, I have received Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior, and yet you don't know him. And yet you don't know him. So like I said, let's see the book of Ephesians 6, 19 to 20. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. God bless you all. Thank you for joining me even at this time. God bless you. Ephesians 6, 19 to 20. The Bible says, but for me, that the utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth. So like I said, an ambassador, there must be something that has been given to you. If there is nothing given to you, there is no even way you will be sent. And there is nothing you can deliver. I keep telling a lot of people, there is no ministry without the word of God. I am going there. There is no ministry without the word of God. Now you want to minister. And yet, even the word you want to minister, you don't even know the word. And who is this word? The word is Jesus. The word is Jesus I'm talking about. The word of God himself is Christ himself. Now, like the Bible says, and for me, my Susan, God bless you. And for me, or as for you, the utterance may be given to us that we may open our mouth boldly. That we may open our mouth boldly to make known the mystery. Hey! Oh yeah, God bless you. To make known the mystery of the gospel. For which, the Bible says, for which you are an ambassador in chains. That in it, we may speak boldly as we ought to speak. How many people are declaring the word of God with boldness again today? A lot of people, out of selfishness, out of greediness, out of because of they want to feed their own belly, out of because they don't want anybody to eat them, out of maybe, oh, I need a lot of crowd. They no longer unlock the real mystery of the gospel to people in order for them to be saved. But all what we are seeing today, like the Bible says, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly. I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. The Bible says in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, for God has not given us the spirit of fear. God has not given us the spirit of fear, nor of timidity, but of power, of love, of self-discipline, in order for us to be able to unlock the mystery of the gospel. So this is a duty. This is the duty of an ambassador. So for now, the Bible also made us understand in the book of 1 Peter. It said, ye are a chosen generation. He chooses you. He picked you out to do something for him. Just like I said, Buhari picked out maybe one man or whosoever he decided to send out to represent him in any country. So God have decided to choose you and I in order for us to represent him. He say, yea, are a chosen generation. a royal priesthood, peculiar people. There is a reason why God have chosen you. He chose you in order for you to represent in himself here on earth. I keep telling people, we are not just here on earth for nothing. So if you know that you are a child of God, you call yourself a Christian, know it that there is something that God has called you to do. You are not just here. You cannot just pass through this world without fulfilling what God have asked you to do, meaning you are going to fail your duty. You will fail your duty. So the Bible is telling you and I tonight that we are ambassadors of Christ here on earth. So that is why I said earlier on that a lot of us, we are failing our duty. We are failing. There is different duty post. A lot of us, we are failing this duty. We claim that we are in Christ Jesus. That is why I keep telling people that just say, okay, let me just, in fact, what will I do now? Oh, I just want to become a church member. Why? I don't want any problem. I don't want any problem. My favor, God bless you all. I just want to become a church member. Becoming a church member alone is not enough for you as a Christian. Child of God, there is a duty far more, how will I put it? There is a duty far more. How will I even put it well? God bless you, for us to understand. Becoming, maybe I just want to go to church on Sunday to just clap my hand. Baba, baba, baba ni Jesu wena. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Then you just finish and go. There is a duty far more behind becoming just an ordinary church member in the church. I keep telling people, if everybody even decide to say, oh, I will just become a church member, you decide to say, no, I will not only become a church member, because why? I know that I am a representative of Christ here on earth. For you to become a representative of Christ here on earth, I keep telling people there is one major thing, which is the great commission that God has called each and every one of us, which is, go ye out there, preach the gospel. I am going there. I just pray that God will help me. There is a duty far more behind. I just come to church on Sunday. Let me just sit down and hear the pastor preach. Let me just sit down and see people minister to me. Let me just sit down and watch the choir sing. There is a duty far more behind that one that God has called each and every Christian for. I don't just talk about believers. I don't even want to be using the name believer, because when we are talking about believer, there are people that believe on Oloku. There are people that believe on Ishango. There are people that believe on Ayelala. There are people that believe on other gods. When I mean the word Christian, I am talking about Christ-like. Not just being Christ-like, but the Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. You follow the footstep of Christ. That is what makes you to become a Christian. Now, where did Jesus come? He came that you and I will be saved. He came that you and I will have light. He came that you and I will leave that darkness completely, and we will see his light. And we will see his light. Now, this is the reason why he came. Now, even when he was not going, even when he finished his course, he left it behind for us to carry on. And let's remember, I keep telling people, he said, greater works. Hey, somebody. Greater works than this shall you do. So that is why if Jesus can say greater works than this, this is what the Bible says, greater works than this. So greater works than this is far more behind, behind you to just go to church on Sunday and you just decide to say, okay, I will just come and sing, and dance, and go. So far, say I go. It's far more behind that, because the Bible says, greater works than this shall you do. If he can tell us that greater works than this, that is what he said to his apostles, greater works than this shall you do. So what are you doing? What works are you doing? And he called you a representative. You carry his identity. Hey, somebody. You carry his identity. You carry his identity. Say, I bear in my body the mark. You carry the mark of Jesus upon your forehead, and yet you are failing your own duty. Even this time around, we need more ambassadors. We need more voices that will speak out, like the Bible says, that we open their mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel. To make known the mystery of the gospel, we need more ambassadors to arise. Like I said, I entered my 2020 with saying, whether the devil likes it or not, darkness is not going to rule over light in this year 2020. And God, we all can see what is going on in the world. I enter my 2020 with saying, darkness will not rule over this year for us. Every power of darkness must be defeated in the name above every other name. So we need more ambassadors that will lift up their voice, that we will lift up our voice to raise up the banner for Jesus, to unlock the mystery of the gospel to as many that are still in the darkness. To as many that are still in the darkness. So let's see the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20 to 21. Like I said, God has not given us the spirit of fear. God has not given you the spirit of fear. What he has given you, he said, that I may open my mouth boldly. That I may open my mouth boldly. This is the Bible for us. That I may open my mouth boldly. Not just opening your mouth, to speak and declare the mystery of the gospel. To declare the mystery of the gospel. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20 to 21. If you are with your Bible, go with me. 2 Corinthians 5, 20 to 21. I'm talking about what it takes to become an ambassador of Christ. And I believe that after this meeting tonight, somebody, you will receive that boldness to go about doing what your father have asked you to do. Like Papa was saying yesterday night, I think I was privileged to connect to Canada. He said something. He said he liked trouble. He just sit down, they look for trouble. Which kind of trouble? Children of God, God does not give birth to cowards. Our father is the lion of the tribe of Judah. Even he is the mighty man in battle. Before we say you are the mighty man in battle, before a man become a mighty man in battle, you know that you must be ready to fight war. You must be ready to war. So this time around, like I keep telling people, it's not a time that we're supposed to be afraid. It's not a time that we're supposed to be afraid. Speak it out boldly, plainly, the way it is. I keep telling people, except you receive the truth, only the truth that is what will set us free. It is only the truth, by the truth that will be free. So we need, in fact, a lot of us, it's time for us to stand up and unlock the mystery of this gospel to people. What is a mystery? Heaven, hell. It is a matter of choice. It's a two-way. Repent. Repent and go to heaven. Or you stay in your wickedness and you go to hellfire. As simple as that. Salvation. So if you repent, you are saved. I have a lot of scriptures like Luke chapter 4 verse 18. That is what the Bible says. If you repent, you are saved. And if you refuse to repent, you will be meant for damnation. But the Bible says that it does not want any soul to perish. So there are lots more as I go tonight. Let me not rush it. So like I said earlier on, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20 to 21. The Bible says, Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. This is the Bible for us. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ as though God were pleasing through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf to be reconciled to God. For he made himself who knew no sin. I've said it beforehand. He made himself who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. So if God himself had made himself that knew no sin to become sin for us, in order for us to become righteousness of God in him. Now, he made himself to become sin for us. He saved. He went down, like we normally used to say, 6 feet down. 6 feet down. In order for today, his name is now highly exalted above every other name. He paid the sacrifice. So an ambassador, you are an ambassador of Christ. And the only sacrifice God is asking each and every one of us to pay is the sacrifice of righteousness to go ye out there and bring in more lost souls. Lost souls. Like we were talking about in church this evening. And it struck my mind again. I said, Father, thank you for glorifying your name. And it even came through one of my minister. Minister Kate, yeah, aka Mama Elliot. When she said it, I just smiled when she said it during her intercessory prayer. She said something. Do you know that the powers of darkness, they are fighting day and night to make sure that they gain more power. There are people, even when she said it, I just laughed. There are people that were ready to pay native doctor, because of you. They are ready to pay native doctor with a awesome amount of money in order for them to say, oh, let me just make sure I will destroy this man. There are people that are ready to sacrifice. They sacrifice more time for their voodoo. They sacrifice more time for their man-made gods. Just incanting and enchanting and enchanting. They sacrifice their time. But Christians, for us to even do what our Father have asked us to do, we are a lot of Christians today that are getting weaker and weaker and weaker. Yes, like I said last week, though is the sign of the end time. But if it's the sign of the end time, you and I must not allow the end time to catch us unaware. That is why we must have to be watchful. You must always have to be in your duty post. Don't go out of your duty post in order for you not to be caught unaware. in order for you not to be caught unaware. So you must not go out of duty. If those that are still in the world are sacrificing money, a lot are sacrificing money for fake prophetess, a lot are sacrificing money for fake prophet, a lot are sacrificing money for native doctors, a lot are sacrificing money for different gods that have no power, then what about you that the power have been given to us? Hey, somebody, what about you that the power have been given to you? You didn't pay for it. You get it free. That is why they normally used to say, something when you not pay for, a lot of us, we don't value it. You see? Because it is not you now. Because it is not me. It is not you that did it. It is not me that did it. That is why I keep telling people, that is why you still see a lot of people, they are taking this grace for granted. And I keep telling us, I pray that we might not, we will not take the grace of God for granted in order for us not to be grounded. Any man or woman that take the grace of God for granted, on the last day you will be grounded in air fire. This is what I keep telling people. Why? Because we did not pay the sacrifice. If it was you and I that paid the sacrifice, oh my goodness, I think you will know the value. We would have known the value more than this. But I have come to announce to somebody tonight, hey somebody, that you are in a duty post. You are a representative of God here on earth. You are representing the greatest king and his kingdom here on earth, representing Jesus. You represent Christ. So this time around is not a time for you to be afraid. Like I said, I just came back from church. I said, let me just go. Let me go. Even if it's 1, 2, 3 persons. I am not here because I'm looking for viewers, like I said. But to God be the glory, God will always, by himself, draw men and women to come and hear his word. Why? You know, when the word of God is coming like this, a lot of people, it's not their fault. I said it last week. A lot of people are looking for itching ear. But let me tell you something. It's our time that we need to wake up. This is a wake-up call for us that call ourselves Christians. I'm not talking about believers. I said it earlier on, anybody can believe on anything. I'm talking about those that have already known Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior. This is the time for us to unlock the mystery of the gospel, behind the gospel, to those that are still in darkness, because at least we ourselves, we have realized that we have received Jesus as our Lord and personal Savior. Like I said last week, when one of my mama said, "Ah, Rachel, your voice is always too loud." I said, "My mama, my voice will be loud, just like the voice of John the Baptist was heard in the wilderness." Yes, the Bible says the voice, before somebody's voice will be heard inside of a wilderness. Do you know the kind of ego-go that John the Baptist was shouting? Because maybe John the Baptist looked at it that if he said small, nobody will want to hear. So my voice, I have decided, just the way that John the Baptist, his voice was being heard in the wilderness. That is how my own voice will be heard. In this time, I need, in fact, let's raise up the banner. Like I keep telling people, before salvation will come, we must shout. Now shout, we go shout. What happened to the children of Jericho? Let me take us back. So that is why, like me, I'm that kind of a person. I don't know how to talk small. I will not pretend to be what I am not. You understand? It's always good that you need to be radical, physically and spiritually, be radical. So I'm that kind of a troublesome human being. Very, very trouble. I am that kind of a troublesome human being. But thank God that God arrested me. So let me now use the trouble for Christ. Let me use it. So when you are first of all troublesome in the world and you now enter Jesus, don't be quiet. The way you were radical when you were in the world, carry the radicalism, enter inside Jesus. So you need to be radical for Christ Jesus. That is why me, I can make trouble. I make trouble. The trouble I am making, I make trouble with the word of God. I will not call what is AB. I will not call what is BZ. And that is why I hate when people are humiliating people. You cannot humiliate somebody because you know that the person is telling you the truth. Which truth? Even when the Bible says, "And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." So the only means a lot of them will hear this gospel is when we shout. John the Baptist is screamed. And remember, the Bible says the kingdom of God suffered violence. Do you know what is violence? And the violence taketh it by force. This year, 2020, we are taking it by force. The kingdom of darkness must bow. And remember, when you allow darkness to begin to prevail, we just think that when we allow darkness to begin to prevail over the world, people of God, let's remember that we are in the world. We are still in the world, despite the fact we are in the world, but we are not of the world. We are in the world as Christians, but we are not of the world. Now, let me tell us something. By the time Christians keep allowing darkness to prevail, it is every one of us that is still inside W-O-R-O-L-E-D. Yes. Then it's only when you really know Jesus, you are in the W-O-R-O-D, that you will be saved. That is why the Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Only the righteous will run in and they are saved. We see what is happening on hell. Is it not everybody that is running at Ascata now? Is everybody? Everybody's running at Ascata. That's why the fact right now is like a joke. But everybody is talking about it. Everybody is sharing it. Go to WhatsApp coronavirus. Go to Messenger coronavirus. Social media coronavirus. I shared one video on my timeline today. You see children, we are even shouting coronavirus. Go back to China. So everybody is on it. Everybody is on it. But we forget about the scriptures that says, if my people that are called by my name, we humble themselves and bow, then I will hear from heaven and I will heal the land. Our land is sick. The world entirely is sick. If the world is sick, it is by the grace of God. Now, Psalm 91 will not come in. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow. That is if you yourself, you dwell in the secret place of the Most High. So I have come to tell us that our duty is far more beyond what a lot of people think that Christianity is today. This is exactly what Apostle Paul says in himself in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. People of God, it's right time we really need to realize that we are aliens. According to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11. 1 Peter 2, 11 to 12. It's time we need to know that we are aliens. We are strangers. We are strangers. We are just like, Mama Susan, God bless you. We are strangers passing through a world. And you cannot just pass through this world just because you want to pass through. You have a destination. You have somebody that have sent you on an errand. Go. That is what he said. Go. I'll be reading a lot of scriptures for us that he said, go, 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 go. Go ye out there. We are like strangers. Imagine, like I said, we are like stranger residents on this earth, but citizens, we are citizenship of heaven. And I make a very good example that an ambassador of Spain, a Nigerian ambassador in Spain, is not from Nigeria. He's from Nigeria and me. He's not a Spanish, they're not born here. It's not a Spanish somebody. It's not a Spanish somebody. So know it that we are of the world, but we are not of the world. We are in the world, but we are not of the world. As Christian, any man or woman that have received Jesus as his Lord and personal Savior, you are in the world, but you are not of the world. You are in the world. Now, as a Christian, you are in the world. Now, W-O-R-O-D, in order for you to be able to change your world, W-O-R-O-L-E-D. I go again. We are in the world as Christians, but we are not of the world now. But we as Christians, we are in the world, which is W-O-R-O-D, in order for us to be able to change our world. But what is happening today is a pity that the world is not changing the W-O-R-O-D. But it will not happen. It will not happen. We will not allow it. We will not allow it. 2020, like I said, is a year that light must prevail over darkness. 2020 is a year that the word of God must be made plain. Like the Bible says, write it down. Make it plain. Make it plain. 2020 is a year that God is going to fish out a lot of righteous voices to raise up the banner for him and said, enough is enough. Enough of this manipulation. Enough of falsehood. Man of God, God bless you, sir. Thank you. Man of God, I trust a lot. I see your thumbs up. So this is the time for you to be in your duty post. This is the time for me to be on my duty post. In order for the WORD, or rather the works of the darkness, not to prevail over us. Like I said, a lot of people are on shrines paying sacrifice. They pay money in order for them to get power. A lot of people, a lot of Christians, you call yourself a child of God, your name is still one in one altar. You call yourself a child of God, your name is still in one babalawo place. You don't know how the name get there. And yet, every day by day, somebody is using your name. It's finding your name. It's finding your name. And yet, you call yourself a child of God, you cannot even get signal. Why? Because you have left your duty post. Return back. Return back. The Bible says, repent now so that a time of refreshing will come. You can still be revived. The word, people, the world have messed. In fact, the world is messing up with a lot of Christians so much. Why? Because we have failed to realize our identity. We have failed to realize we are on a duty. You are on a duty as an ambassador. You represent Christ. And the moment you represent Christ, the kingdom of darkness said they're supposed to know. Say, ah, this one, eh? It matter. Anywhere they measure your name, as they measure your name, they go see fire. Yeah. They go see fire. Fire go answer. But today is an error. As an ambassador of Christ, somebody can just carry your name to one voodoo and begin to fan. So when my minister said that thing this evening in church, I said, Father, thank you for glorifying your name. Thank you for glorifying your name. I don't know who is that man, that woman that have left his or her duty post. Return back and do what your father have asked you to do. For God has not given you the spirit of fear. So like I said earlier on, this is exactly, we are citizenship of heaven, but right here on earth, we are like strangers. There is a duty we have been called. So we are Christ's representative in this world. We are Christ's representative in this world. Or are we like those apostles, like apostles? Let's see the book of Philippians chapter 3 verse 17. Let me read the Bible, Philippians 3, 17 and verse 19. Let me read the Bible for us. So like I said, even Zacchaeus, I wanted to give an example of Zacchaeus. Something happened before salvation came to the house of Zacchaeus. He climbed the sycamore tree and he was shouting. The Bible said he screamed. He shouted. The wall of Jericho, before they were able to possess it, it was at the seventh time. They screamed. They shouted. They screamed. They shouted before the wall collapsed. That is salvation. Before they were saved. Before they took over. Before the victory come. So sometimes that is the violence. That is the violence. We are ready to take it by force. The world itself must bow for the world. It is not the world that we bow for. That is, let me be using it well. It is not the WORD that we bow for WORLD. It is WORLED that we bow for WORD. That is why God has called you an ambassador to represent him here on earth. And that is why he has called me. So we must not fail God because he did not fail us. He paid the sacrifice. So like I said, if men, women can be paying huge amount of money to get power. They pay money to just get evil, to do evil. Why can't we just, I'm happy, God bless you. Why can't we just pay this sacrifice? What is the sacrifice? The sacrifice of obedience to God. The sacrifice of just giving him your time. The sacrifice of just saying, Father, here I am. Okay, I am ready now. Use me. Do with me whatever that pleases you. As an ambassador, yes. You are not just here on earth. What does a king do? You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, peculiar people. A royalty. What kind of honor is that? What does a king do? A king will sit down and begin to give instructions. That is how we are here on earth. We are representative. We have come to represent Christ. And the only instructions we are to give to the kingdom of darkness is this. You must bow. You must join us. In fact, you must join us to serve this God. We must not join them to serve the world, but they will join us to serve our God. They must. It's a must. So I don't know about you. I don't know the decision. But I am here to let us know that we are on a mission. We are not just here on earth because we want to be on earth. So Philippians chapter 3, like I said, Philippians 3 verse 17. Let me read the Bible. Philippians 3 verse 17. The Bible says, brethren, join in. Brethren, join in. Following my example. And not those who so walk as you have also for a pattern. For many walk of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping that they are the enemies of the cross. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus, who will transform our lowly body, that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to the working by which he is able to even to subdue all things to himself. Is this not amazing? So you can see that your citizenship is in heaven. So being a stranger, or we are just on earth. We are like strangers. We are like just like on a, we are in a journey. We are just passing. And you will not just want to journey because you just want to be here. God just created you. That is why I keep telling people that I say, salvation, you know, is a personal business. I keep telling people when it comes between you and God, salvation is personal. But when it comes to the to the to why God has really brought you out. I've given you that salvation. It's no longer personal. It becomes the business of everybody. Yes, our Father's business is our business. That is why they said in the book of Acts of Apostles, when they wanted to appoint Stephen, they said, who are we going to appoint over our Father's business? So when it comes to the business of God, it's everybody must be involved. That is why I said, many are called, few are chosen. The harvest truly is plentiful, but the laborers are few. So like I said last week, we must be involved. We must be involved in order for us to harvest bountifully. In this time, in this perilous time, in this end time, we must be involved. You must be involved. I must be involved in order for us to be able to harvest bountifully. And now, how do you involve yourself and how do I involve myself? That is where I am going now. How do you involve yourself and how do I involve myself? I keep telling people, just think of that little thing you will do for that man or that woman to be saved. I'm happy. God bless you. Think of that little thing, that you think that is little, but in the sight of God, it's not little. There is no word of God that is little. Jesus loves you. It's not little. Jesus loves you. It's not little. Any Christian who sees himself or less than a citizenship of heaven and an ambassador of Christ in this world is of no use to God. Any man or woman, let me not use any Christian, any man or woman that does not see himself as a citizenship of heaven, or rather as a representative. Now, when I'm talking about representative, we represent somebody here on earth. That is why we are Christians. So, for you to even represent at all, that is what makes you to become an ambassador. Because like I defined for us, an ambassador is a person that represents his own country in a far distance. In a very far distance. So our citizenship is in heaven, but now we are representing the kingdom of God here on earth. We represent God himself. So by the time you don't even see yourself as a representative of God, or rather you don't even see yourself as a citizenship of heaven, you are of no use to God. You are of no use to God, but I pray that we'll be useful for God in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible says it does not want to see any soul perish. So I believe we all know. We all know the adage that says anything that is not useful is useless. That is why the Bible says in the book of Revelation, you neither be hot or you are cold. Okay, you are not hot. You are not cold. Which one you can't day? Eh? You are not hot. You are not cold. Which era do you belong to? And the word of God said, those kind of people, the Bible says, I will spit you out. I will just spit you out because I don't even know where you belong to. A lot of people are still like that in the world. They don't even know if they are for God or they are for the world. If they are for God or they are for the devil. Eh? Choose it these days who you will serve. You cannot serve two masters at the same time. You must have to follow one. And the only one that they have come to announce to you tonight is Jesus. It's Jesus. So if you have not seen known him, now is the time. But if you have already known him, you said you have received him as your Lord and personal Savior, but yet you are not doing what he has asked you to do. Now is the time for you to return back to God. Like we saw it in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 19 to 20. Now, what does it take to be an ambassador? What does it actually take? Now, according to Ephesians chapter 6 verse 19 to 20, we see that the art of an ambassador is prayer. The number one thing, what does it take? For you to really become an ambassador of Christ, you must learn how to pray without ceasing. The Bible says, when men slept, the evil ones come to sow ties. A lot of us, we have been sleeping for so long. That is why you see the devil was like, it's like they are succeeding. I keep telling people, do you know why a lot of people fail that? They fail to believe that really you have received Jesus as a Lord and personal Savior. Let me tell us something. Do you know the reason why a lot of people fail that power that God has given to you is not in you? Do you know why a lot of people fail that you are not really a Christian? Why? There are a lot of people that are evil around us. We eat with them, we drink with them, we laugh with them. But yet, like the Bible says, and a man's enemies shall be members of his own household. A lot of them that are evil around us, they do all manners of evil that is smelling around us, but still you are still in their midst. You are still following them to do those things that they are doing. They will not say, hey, see this one that says she's a Christian. Look at this one that says he's a Christian. So upon all this Baba thing that we are even doing to him or to her, so she cannot even see it. And yes, she says she's a Christian. You will not even see it because why? You are still in the midst of darkness. So the art of the first thing, the art of an ambassador is prayer. The art of an ambassador is prayer. So before any little thing, you have already seen that thing coming. Even when that thing will still come, that thing might not come in order for God to try your faith, or rather to test your faith, but you will overcome. I keep telling people, that adage we normally used to say, now waiting person don't know, now they kill and I lie. It's not correct. Now waiting you know, now not go kill you. Because why? You already have idea of it, somebody. Because why? You already have a clue of it. The Bible says in John 10 verse 10, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, to destroy, but God have come to give us light. So it is what you don't know that will harm you. But if you are already aware of it, even if that thing now come, it will not be worse like you don't even know anything about it. But let me tell you something, God will still see you through. God will still see you through. This is the reason why you see a lot of people, they don't even have respect, sorry to say, for genuine men and women of God again. Yes. This is the reason why you see a lot of people don't even have respect for ministers of God again. Because even in the midst of the shit, even in the midst of the nonsense, even in the midst of the darkness, you are still there. You are not able to see anything. They will not believe on your anointing. They will not believe that you carry the grace. They will not believe. Because it don't get in fact, if that thing is not staying for so long, they will even say, I bet, just forget. This one, he know if they see anything. That is the reason why you see a lot of men and women of God today is like, even the sea finish. Let us, like sometimes we will say, any grace that you want to work for you, don't just be too close. Don't associate yourself too much with it in order for you to still be having respect for it. I have seen things real, my people. Yes. You see somebody who just, I bet they go this part. Even people even say, if this thing that I am doing, he said he's a pastor, why can't him see it? So even if, like I said, you don't even want to go far, but there is you need to put a limit. At least let that woman know, say, you they see. Let that woman know, say, I know who you be. I know who you be. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. Who are you? You understand? This is the reason why you see a lot of things are going wrong today. Somebody that is killing you, you will still carry the person and use the person to be sewing agbada and wear. The person will never believe that you are a child of God. The person will not believe you. We are here for a duty. So the art of an ambassador is prayer. It's prayer. You must be prayerful. Like I said, a lot of them pay sacrifice to voodoo. A lot of them pay sacrifice to fake pastors, to fake men of God. I'm not talking about sowing a seed in a fertile ground. Mama Gift, my boss mama in the house, God bless you. Mama Happy, God bless you. Thank you for joining. A lot of them pay money, pay sacrifice. Because why? They want to bring people down. Have we not seen them? I have seen a situation whereby a best friend of somebody take the person's, let me say Mr. A and Mr. B. Now, Mr. A and Mr. B, or Mrs. A and Mrs. B, they are friends, best of friends. Mrs. B take Mr. A husband's name to a fake prophet, and they lock the man inside of a bottle. And still, Mrs. A is a Christian. Mrs. A used to go to church. Mrs. A, in fact, she's a Christian, but she could not see it. Why? Because even the Mrs. B, we still come to Mrs. A house. They still eat together. They still drink together. They still dine together. What fellowship does righteousness have with unrighteousness, my people? This is the reason why you see a lot of us, we fail to see to see what God is doing. We fail to see things. Know that God is not still speaking. God can still speak to you when you disconnect yourself from darkness. That is the reason why you are a representative of God. Just like President Buhari, if the Nigeria ambassador in Spain, or the Nigeria representative, or whatsoever, how will I put it, the ambassador of the Nigeria embassy here in Spain disconnect from President Buhari, there will no longer be communication. Let's tell ourselves the truth. A lot of things will go wrong. Yeah. A lot of things will go wrong before then. This is exactly what a lot of us is doing today. You are in the midst. That is why the Bible says evil communications corrupt good manner. Watch your company, watch your association, watch the groups you belong to, watch your cycle. Because the moment you see, you see, how will I put it? Like me, I can know, I'll say, this one, I don't already know you. But in order for me not to just now develop, God forbid, hatred, At least, I still keep on, good morning, good afternoon. We still talk, you understand? But I've already know the kind of person you are. But that relationship can never be as it was from day one when I've not known you. Yes. That relationship can never be close again as it was from day one when I've not known the kind of person you are. It can never lie. But the Bible says, unto the Jews, I behave like a Jew. Unto the Greeks, I still behave like a Greek, that I might still be able to win them back to Christ. To win them back to Christ. So what am I trying to say? The act of an ambassador of Christ is prayer. Is your prayer life going down? Know that the devil is at work. Know that the powers of darkness is at work. Because they know fully well, child of God, that if you pray, your eyes will be opened. They know fully well that if you pray, your ears will begin to hear, get signal. They know fully well that if you pray, by the time you just close your eye like this, you will receive trance. That is why you see a lot of us today, the devil is trying to affect our prayer lives in order for us not to do what? In order for us not to be able to get their network, or rather to get their signal. In order for us not to be able to design them. But child of God, let me tell you something. By the time you did not disconnect yourself, that is why sometimes I love welfare prayer. That is why sometimes I love violence prayer. You pray it violence. You break yourself out from that darkness. You pull yourself down. Then by the time you are in the far distance, at least, how far now? Hey, we do. Hey, how are you? You understand? You are no longer close. A man's foes is a member of his own household. Any man or any woman that does not have your information, your gist, will not be able to arm you. This is where a lot of us will get it wrong today. I be Christian. No, you must not just carry everybody and use that to swag badam. That is why I keep telling people the best association you can keep is an association that we, in one way or the other, encourage you to grow in spiritual things. Yes. Encourage you to grow in spiritual things. But when you are in the midst, or rather in an association that everything that happened there is worldliness, a lot of things will be happening to your destiny. If you are not even careful, some of them will even be using your star, your glory, to begin to shine. And you are in their midst, so you are not seeing anything. How will they not believe that you are a representative of God here on earth? They will just be laughing at you. That is the Paul I know. Jesus I know. Who are you? If you claim that you are a child of God, you would have been able to see it. Sometimes you might not see it at the beginning. But child of God, let me tell you something. As you keep on firing your prayer life. So I want to encourage somebody tonight. In any area that you see that your prayer life is going down, you no longer pray the way you are supposed to pray. Somebody know it. That something is wrong. And let me tell us another thing. Maybe when you see that there are raises of kind of welfare prayer, the devil will now begin to minister some funny things to you. This enemy, die. Yes, I keep telling people there is different. In a church, there should be, how would I put it? In church, there should be orderliness. We should not use the time for intercessory prayer, for praise and worship. We should not use the time for praise and worship for offering. We will not use the time for offering for the message. When it comes to the time for message, is that the time for the message is to unlock the mystery of the gospel to the people. Then when it comes to the time of welfare, intercessory prayer, you can wage war. That is where the Bible now says the kingdom of God. See, let me tell us something. The devil, the devil and his agents, they are people that don't have mercy. They don't get mercy. So when you fold your hands, if you are not careful, God forbid that they will cut somebody's destiny short. So you need to be vibrant in your spirit, in your spiritual life as well. That is why the Bible says, pray without ceasing. I have come to announce to somebody that the devil himself has no mercy. They will not get mercy. So the art of an ambassador must be prayer. Because through prayer, you'll be able to receive signal from the one that sent you. Through prayer, you will not be disconnected from the network. Through prayer, you will not be there will be no disconnection. You will no longer be running letter-skater and looking for people that want to go and pray it for you. A lot of people pay men and women of God to fast and pray for them. What are you doing? You are on a duty post. What are you doing? You pay somebody to fast and pray for you. For what? When the Bible says greater works than this shall you do, you are failing your duty already. Yes. You are failing your duty already. So what am I trying to say? Let our heart be artfully yield to God in prayers. There is no greater threat to God's kingdom than a prayerless ambassador who, in the name of Christ, go about doing their own will. A lot of them today, they claim that they are ambassadors, but they are after selfishness, greediness, and the Bible says their God is in their belly. They have left what God has asked them to do, and they are running after their stomach. Self-centeredness, greediness, and yet we are running after them. Hey, somebody. People that are greedy, they are self-centered. They want to run after their own stomach. They want to work for their own father. Because the Bible says that the devil is the father of principalities, powers. The devil is the father of, in fact, every forces of darkness, every agent of darkness. The devil is their father. And a lot of us, we are running after them instead of them to run after us. It's an error as a representative of Christ here on earth. So there is no greater threat to the kingdom of God than a prayerless ambassador who, in the name of Christ, go about doing his own will. I'm happy. God bless you. He who, in the name of Christ, created confusion, disruption, destroying the world in the name of Christ. So as Christians, our prayer life ought to be the number one of the most, of the most direct link to God. You want to hear from God? You are on a duty post. A lot of us, we have been disconnected. They are looking for you around 3 o'clock. They will call your name in one shrine. Before they call you, teacher, you don't answer. Hey, as a child of God. They are looking for you in one voodoo shrine. As they are finding your name. Before they even mention your name, you don't answer. I keep telling people, even when you are asleep, let your spirit be vibrant. That any altar, any evil altar, they will mention your name. In fact, Holy Ghost fire will answer there for us in the name of Jesus. So a lot of us, we have been sleeping, and they have sold a lot of evil ties that we cannot even see again, we cannot hear again, but yet we say we are children of God. It's an error. So let's wake up our prayer life again. Wake it up. So if you have been that time that you see yourself, your prayer life is going down, child of God, know that something is wrong somewhere. There are some certain things that the devil don't want you to see. Yeah. There are some certain things that the devil don't even want you to see. You cannot even pray before you sleep. You wake up, you cannot even remember your dream. And inside that of your dream, they have done all kind of different kind of things. Oh, inside that dream. Inside that dream. A lot are happening. We are in a very wicked world, eh? The world is wicked. It's wicked. So you need to wake up. Wake up. Be vibrant. Be vibrant. I put a post this morning. I said, every plan of our enemy, every evil plan of our enemy against us, it will be several times fold. That is what they will get. Because the Bible says they come in one way and they will flee away several ways. So as they are coming in one way to bring the problem in one way, as they are going, we give them several to carry back. Yes. They bring one to us. But as they are going back, they go with seven. Sevenfold, we dash it to them. My mama in church, my pastor's wife, we always say, they come to you, they scatter. You go to them, they scatter. That is an ambassador of Christ. They come to you, they scatter. You go to them, you scatter. Anywhere they call your name, scatter. That is why, like I said, you need to be vibrant. So when your prayer life is going down, child of God, know that something is wrong somewhere. Wake up! I repeat, when men slept, the evil ones come to sow ties. They have toyed with Christians for so long. The powers of darkness have been ruling for so long. Now is the time for the name of Jesus to be lifted high again. Because his name, surely, will be lifted high above every other name. We have kept quiet for so long. And that is why you must not associate with the powers of darkness. He who wants to fight darkness must not be in darkness, or else the devil will mess you up. He who wants to fight darkness must not be in the midst of darkness, because or else the devil will mesmerize you. The devil will mess you up. The devil will mess you up. How do you go? Do you think that the devil is a man that you will just carry bread? Bread and butter and say, come and take. Devil that does not even have respect for his own maker. Like I used to say. The devil that does not even have respect for Jesus. See Jesus. He was still bold to tempt him. He was still bold. See Jesus. Devil that did not even have respect for his own creator. Devil that did not even have respect for his own maker. You not think the devil will have respect for you? The only thing that will make devil to have respect for you is when you know who you are. You know what you carry. Devil not get respect for anybody. then you want to show mercy. That is why I keep telling people that I've not seen anything. Be praying gentleman prayer. Just be praying gentleman prayer. Hey, the Bible says we should pray for our enemies. The Bible says we should pray for our enemies. You need to be wise. Even when you are doing all those prayers, be very, very careful, because the devil himself has no mercy. I'm telling us. He has no mercy. He was able to take Jesus. He followed him to the wilderness. He said, oh yeah, fall. You see this old earth, the earth that he created, he was tempting his own master again with the old earth, with his creation. Then that kind of a man, is whom you think that you will joke with. So if your prayer life is down, child of God, wake it up. Wake it up. Like I said, the area they get most of us is, all this die. When it comes to die, pray it. It's God that will answer. You are not the one that is killing anybody. You don't even have right to kill. Our own is to pray. We leave the rest for God to answer. Elijah said, if I be a man of God, let fire come up. I be that one and see Old Testament in all the inside Bible again. May God help us. May our eyes be open. Who not go? Now, no, no. Like I shared a video of Pastor Chris that he said, throw them out, pull them down. He said, I have given you the power to tread upon serpent and scorpion. The power to reject them, the power to rebuke them, the power to destroy them. Then you want to destroy them with gentleman prayer. No. So when it comes to the time of the word of God, we unlock the mystery of the gospel. When it comes to welfare, by yourself, and also maybe you go to tell one prophet or one prophetess or one pastor, maybe they tell you one witch or one wizard that say, come and kill. No. By yourself, pray the prayer. You leave it for God to answer. You leave it for God to answer. So we need to wake up our prayer life. That is the number one thing of an ambassador. So you want to get signal from God. You want to hear from God. You need to wake up. Wake up your spiritual life by yourself. Nobody will do it for you. Nobody will do it for you. So it's high time we allow our heart to be artfully yielded to God in prayers, granted with his written word. Jesus self was able to defeat Satan with the spoken word. Jesus was able to defeat devil with the spoken word. It is written. 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 How will he be able to defeat the devil when the word of God, you are not equipped? The word of God is not there. I read the book of Ephesians for us. Let me go to that Ephesians chapter 6 again. I read it last week. The Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. My ambassador, my representative, my child, my son, my daughter, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor. Hey, the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand the wiles of the devil. Jesus himself was able to withstand the wiles of the devil with the spoken word. With the word of God. So without the word of God in you, it will hard. That is why you need to study to show yourself approved. If you have been paying money for them to do it for you, don't pay them any longer. You tell yourself, I can do it all by myself. Yes, I can do it all by myself. Then you can join your faith with the faith of, not that you yourself, in the thing no evil day, you just, how will you be paying money for prayers? That is the number one thing. How do you pay money for prayers? And the person that not collect it, you not think that the person will even pray for God to hear. The person is not praying for the God I know to hear. The person might be praying to his or her own God to hear. He's not praying because God, he said, freely I give and freely you will receive. So stop paying money for prayers for people to pray for you. Stop it. You are covenanting yourself with powers that you don't know where they get their powers from. Child of God, wake up your spiritual life by yourself. You can do it. So you want to fight the devil? He said, put on the old armor. You cannot fight when you don't have the word. Like I said, Christ himself was able to stand against the ways of the devil by the spoken word. By the spoken word of God. The devil is not a man that you think that you can just bounce on. He's not a man that you think that you can just jump on. He's not a man. A man that has seen the kingdom. Where you and I, we have not seen. He has seen it. He has been there. His eyes have saw everything. Day in and day out, we keep fighting to see that we will make it. We keep fighting to see that we will get there. But he has been there. He has seen everything that is there. And he does not even want you to go there. Then you think that such a man is a man that you can just go with. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, surely goodness and your mercy shall follow me. You think it's such a man. You will be able to defeat him. Child of God, wake up your spiritual life. I have come to wake up. It's a wake-up call that you are not just on earth because you want to be on earth. You are on earth for a reason. There is a reason why God has called you. He has called you to represent. And before you want to represent God's kingdom, you must be guided by the word. He said, put on the whole armor that you may be able to stand. For we rescue not against flesh and blood. We rescue not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this age. There are powers that are in charge of the world. But we are in charge of the WOROD. But God has made us to supersede them. Yes. And we must rule over them. They must not rule over us. Any man or any woman that allow the powers of the world to rule over. That is why I say such a man or such a woman. Your destination, God forbid. Because the devil is the only man that I know that he uses people and useless them. God can never use you and useless you. God will use you and make you to be useful. And on that last day, hey, you say, well done, good and faithful servant. So your service to God is far more beyond becoming an ordinary church member. Yes, we can see it. Your service to God is far more beyond that. It's far more beyond that. Becoming an ordinary church goer. It's far more beyond it. Just like I said, relationship, personal relationship with God, you need to add it up with work. I will be reading a lot of scriptures for us today before I go. So let me rush it down. Romans chapter 10, verse 14 to 15. Now, another, the words of an ambassador is the gospel. Like I said, what does it take for you to become an ambassador? Number one, for you to become an ambassador of Christ, your everything about your heart, you're supposed to be yield to God in prayer. Because without prayer, you will not be able to get signs or instruction or signal from God. It's just like you are still walking in darkness. So now, after you give yourself to prayer, now the word, the gospel, word of an ambassador is the gospel. Your words will become the gospel. Let's see the book of Romans chapter 10, verse 14 to 15. Romans 10, 14 to 15. Romans chapter 10, verse 14 to 15. The Bible says, how then shall they call on him whom they have not believed? And how then shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how then shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach unless they are sent, as it is written? We cannot preach because no man or woman can preach if he or she is still in darkness. But you and I, we can preach today because we have been sent by the Lord. They must hear also. These powers of darkness must hear whether they like it or not. How then can they preach unless they are sent, as it is written? How beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good news. But they have not all obeyed the gospel, for Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed our report? So then faith cometh by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. So the words of an ambassador is the gospel. When you talk about the gospel. When you minister the gospel. When you preach the gospel. So as an ambassador, we need to fully understand the message of the gospel before passing it on onto those. Before carrying the message. But today we have different contradicting gospel messages here and there, contradicting. And after contradicting the message, they will still tell us to go and buy the CD plate. We will still carry our money to go and buy the CD plate and begin to watch. It's an error as a child of God. Yes. It's a very big error. Different. In fact, very soon, they will break up the Old Testament. In fact, I keep telling people, if the Old Testament is no longer a part of the Bible, we would have just come and meet from Matthew to Revelation. There would have been no Genesis to Malachi. At least Matthew to Revelation is enough for us. Yes. A lot of contradicting messages. So as an ambassador, first of all, you need to understand the message that you want to give to your people. Because without you understanding what you have been sent, there is no way you can deliver. If I decide to send my children on an errand and they don't understand that message, they will go and mess up themselves because they don't really understand what I am sending them to do. Until a child of God, you realize or you know what you have been asked to do before you'll be able to carry the message to the people that you have been sent to. God has sent us to a lot of people. Like I said, though, fire is not still going to be empty. Fire is not going to be empty. There is still going to be a lot of population in air, whether we like it or not. It's not everyone that will make the heaven. Yeah. That is why he said, many are called, few are chosen. And he said on that day, he's going to tell a lot of them, go. I know you not. Ye workers of iniquity. So this is to say, a lot of people, God is still going to tell them, go. But as many that God is going to tell them, go, it will not be you, it will not be me. That is why we still have the chance now to do what God has asked us to do. So there is a responsibility we have to take serious. Especially in this end time, especially in this perilous time, there is a responsibility we need to take serious. Our calling is not to master guilt, but of duty and privilege. We are privileged servants of the Most High God. You have been privileged to have been called for a duty. Like the Bible says, we are laborers together with God. We labor with Him. We walk with Him. We walk alongside. We walk for Him. So the words of an ambassador is the gospel. It's the gospel message. And you must have to understand the message in order for you to be able to carry it to those that God have sent you to. And that is why I keep saying this time around, when it comes to the word of God in the church, let us try to preach more about salvation. It's not everybody that is still in the house of God that is saved. But by the time we keep preaching prosperity, 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 you pray your way to prosperity and you work for prosperity. Yes, you pray for prosperity and you work for prosperity. So prosperity is not something that we're supposed to preach. It's not something that we're supposed to preach. I don't know if anybody is getting me. It's not something we're supposed to preach. It's something you need to pray for and you work for it. As simple as that. You work for it and you pray for it. The Bible says, blessed is a man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, but it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whose leaf will not do what? Will never wither. So there are guidelines for prosperity. There are things that you need to do and you will prosper. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and every other thing shall be added. So I keep telling people, you want to prosper, walk. Support it and let God try to do something. Not by every now and then, all what we hear is prosperity. And this is where the devil is getting a lot of people today. So the message, we need to understand more about the mystery of the gospel. And every mystery that is behind the gospel is salvation, repentance, holiness. Let's preach it to them. That is why we have been sent. I am going there. It's in the scripture. Like I said, God is against poverty, but you don't want to be poor. Walk. Because the power to make wealth has been given to you. This is what I keep telling people. Yeah. We don't supposed to preach prosperity. We pray for it. We work for it. When you pray, go and walk. Faith without work is dead. This is the Bible for us. So it's our time we need to unlock the mystery. We can pray whenever we want to pray. Take charge. The riches of the Gentiles is mine. After you bombast it, you pray. Then go and walk. Then the spiritual will not materialize into the physical. That is how I used to say my own. But when it comes to the mystery of the gospel, unlock the kingdom. Unlock the good news. Unlock it in order for people that are in the darkness to be saved. So an ambassador of Christ, the words of an ambassador is the gospel. But you must have to understand the gospel before you carry it out to those that you are sent to. That is why we still see a lot of people today is like they are in church, but they are out of the church. They go to church, but they are still outside. There are a lot of people like that. They go to church, but they are still outside the church. They are still like those people that are still, you understand, let me not go there, that have not heard. We have a lot of them. But by the time we begin to unlock the mystery of the gospel, before that person will be going to church on Sunday, he will be thinking, I never know the one carry this Bible go again today. Their heart will be beating. Heart go they fear. He said, enter. Who can enter? Come boldly to the throne of grace with boldness. Yes, somebody. You cannot enter the heart of God with fittiness. You cannot enter the house of God unclean. But we have all manners of evil spirits, even inside the church of today. They feel themselves comfortable. They are comfortable. Even when the word of God is going or they cross their leg, they are looking. They are looking like this. Pastor, they will even be the one that will be shouting, Pastor, write down, preach the message and tell us why. Because we are giving them what they want to hear. It's our time we need to unlock the mystery. Let's unlock it. Time not day for us again. Mama, God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for coming in. God bless you, ma. You understand? So the message of the kingdom is of duty and privilege. It's not of guilt. It's not of guilt. I'm trying to run it now. Then the number three thing is faith. For you to become an ambassador of Christ, you must have to have that faith. You must have to be fearless. You must have to be fearless. Many of us, we are still having the thought of, where do I start from? How can I proceed? Where do I start from? How can I proceed? People of God, we need to unlock the mystery of the gospel. Yes, in an act of faith. If the church is the only place that the name of Christ is spoken, or rather the church is the only place where people, at least they gather, they come to hear the name of, they might just say, okay, let me just go to church today. But when they come, they hear the mystery. Hey, at least the church can still save more multitude now. Can still save. So let's pay very close attention, like to what Paul says in that book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. Let's pay very close attention to it and keep on praying that God will give us the ability to be fearless. To be fearless, to speak the word of God in truth. Repent or you die, and so the kingdom be. But God does not want any soul to perish. Are you still indulging yourself in wickedness? Repent or you die. Repent or you perish in a fire. As simple as that. So what am I trying to say? God has not given us the spirit of fear. That is where the faith comes in. Have the faith that you can do it. Have the faith that you are not afraid of darkness any longer. Because why? You don't belong to them any longer. You are not for them. You don't associate with them any longer. You don't associate with them any longer. And that is why you must disconnect yourself from every forces of darkness. Put on the old armor that you may be able to stand against the wills, the wiles of the devil. They are tricks. They are evil. They are deceits. They are manipulation. But when the old armor is not there, they can manipulate you and use you anyhow. God forbid, they will not use you. They will not use me. That is why I said, it's our time. We need to be wise. So it's time for us to know that preaching the gospel is a step outside our comfort zone. It's a step. You need to go further. Move further. Move further. Like in 2 Corinthians 5 verse 20 to 21, I urge every one of us that we should not allow anything to raise our anxiety level higher than telling people about Jesus. This is the time. Because why? We know that the time is at hand, whether we like it or not. Like I said, any man that died today, that one is rapture. So the rapture is taking place with anyhow. But like I keep saying, we will not die, but we will live to declare the word of God in the land of the living. But let's do what God has asked us to do. Live a righteous life. Live a holy life. Carry your cross and follow him. Speak the truth at all time. Preach truth. And when you are preaching truth, you are preaching Jesus. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And he said, no man cometh unto the Father except through him. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So when you preach truth, you preach the word of God, you are preaching Christ, you are preaching Jesus as well. So let us go beyond the call of our duty and take it as a responsibility and a privilege to make known to the world, to make known to the powers of darkness, to make known to the kingdom of darkness, the gospel, not just the gospel, but the mystery of the gospel of Christ. God has sent us to be representative, to do his will, to speak his word. We should not allow fear of men. Yes, this is where a lot of us, we are failing it today. We should not allow the fear of men to keep us from being who God says we want to be for him. Don't allow your past. Apostle Paul said, hey, I am just forgetting those things that are behind. I don't live those things. Even when the devil is trying to remind you of your past, the devil is a very tricky human being. He will always want to use all manners, all ways, to make sure that he will tell you that you cannot do it. He wants to remind you of your past all the time. But press forward. Forget those things that are behind and look forth unto the crown of glory that is ahead of you. That is ahead of you. We should not allow fear of men, or neither the fear of the powers of darkness, or neither the fear of the kingdom of darkness, or rather the workers of darkness, to hold us down. Don't allow it. Because by the time you allow it, they are trying to cover your... They are trying to just try... There are certain things that they don't want you to know. There are certain things that they don't want you to know. My prayer for us tonight is that may God by himself deliver a lot of many people. Too much wickedness, like I keep telling us. Too much wickedness in the world. I will not really want to keep us because I started late. Let me not say late, but all to the glory of God. There are some scriptures I want to read for us. The mystery of the kingdom. Mama Mercy, God bless you for joining. The mystery of the kingdom. Can we see the book of Mark chapter 16 verse 15? So as a representative, there is something that God has asked you. Mark 16, 15 to 16. Hallelujah. What does it take to become an ambassador? Mark 15. No, let me read 16. 16, 15 to 16. The Bible says, and he said to them, this was Jesus, and he said to them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, he who believes. The Bible says, God has sent you. He has already sent you. So your own is to go and do what the Lord have asked you to do. But the Bible says, even when you go about doing it, he who believes. And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creation. Now, you going into the world, you are not just going into the WORLD, but you have the you are not just going into the WORLD. That is where he have asked us to go, which we are in today. But there is something that you carry that you want to deliver to the world, which is the WORD, which is the gospel, which is Jesus. Which is Jesus. Now, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. And the Bible says, but he who do not believe he will be condemned. And these signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not by any means hurt them. But they will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. How many of us are doing these things today? Let's tell ourselves the truth. Yes. And yet we say we believe in the name of Jesus. And yet we run after people that are doing it. We run after them. Instead of you to just keep on working on yourself gradually. And you will see that God will take you there. Child of God is just sacrifice. All we need is sacrifice. Like seriously. The way we sacrifice our time, like I keep saying, maybe like to watch movie, to watch television, to be on internet, to be on our jobs, to be on our businesses. If we sacrifice the time like that in our closet, oh my God, that greater works than this. We will do it. This is what the Bible is saying. So your own is to go. Do what your Heavenly Father have asked you to do. Just go about doing it. There is not left for God to do what he says he will do. Because the Bible says, he who believes will be saved. And he who does not believe, the Bible says, such a man or such a woman is meant for what? For damnation. It's meant for what? For condemnation. But let's remember, the Bible says, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. So becoming an ambassador of Christ, he called you an ambassador. You have believed that yes, I've received Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior. You are already a representative of Christ. Now, you have the word. You have Jesus to deliver to the world. You have Jesus to deliver to those that are still in the darkness. Because why? Jesus himself is light. He's light. I am going there. Himself is light. So you are already a carrier of his presence. You don't just carry the presence of God for nothing. You have not just been called a royal priesthood, peculiar people. You are a king or a queen, or rather a daughter of a king or a queen. Eh? They become prince and princesses in the kingdom. We reign, we rule. We reign, we rule, we reign, we rule. Yes, that is our identity. So when you realize that your identity is to reign and to rule, you will not allow worldliness or those that are still in the world. Like me, that is why I keep telling people, even if I see some people with private jets, I will never envy them. There are some people you even see with private jets. You don't even envy them because you are better than them. Sorry to say. There are some people you see in a mansion. They live in mansion. No need to envy them. Because why? You that is even maybe living in one room and you have Jesus. You are better than them that are living in a mansion and they don't have Jesus. There is a very big difference between you and them. I'm telling you the truth. Only if we realize these little things, you will not begin to kill yourself and worry yourself over things that are supposed not to be. Because why? You know who you are in Christ Jesus. This is where a lot of people get it wrong. So there are some people, no matter what I see, I can never envy them because I know who I am in Christ Jesus. You know who you are in Christ Jesus. So when I keep seeing people, they are just being, you just try to be jealous and you begin to hate. When you even say you are a Christian, first of all, you are not a Christian. Those things are meant for people that are in the world. This is what I keep telling people. Because why? Something more than gold. The spirit of the Lord in the life of a man is something more than gold. It's something more than riches. The Bible says Christ in us is the hope of our glory. A lot of us have been failing. That is why you see a lot of Christians today, they still have high blood pressure. What is giving you depression? What is giving you sleepless nights? What is giving you tension? What is giving you tension? You have Jesus, you still have all these things. It's not supposed to be meant for us as Christians. Yes. But even if you have had them accidentally, I am bringing you the word of God, child of God, relax. Relax. Because why? Christ in you is the hope of your glory. So that is Mark chapter 16, verse 15 to 16. Go ye into the world, preach it. Your own is to preach it. They yell, it will be good for them. They don't yell, now they're sabi. As simple as that. That is it. Acts of Apostles chapter 13, verse 47. Let's see what the Bible says. Acts 13, 47. Let's see what the Bible tells us in the book of Acts of Apostles. This is the mystery of the kingdom, the gospel. Acts 13, 47. Let's see what the scripture says. I've read Mark 16, I mean. So let me go to Acts 13, 47. Acts 13, 47. The word of God says, child of God, for so the Lord commanded us. I have set you, I have set you as a light to the Gentiles, that you should be for salvation to the ends of the earth. The mystery of the gospel, salvation. The first one is say, go ye into the world and preach the gospel. Now, which gospel? Then it said in the book of Acts of Apostles 13:47. Now, Acts of Apostles, for so the Lord has commanded us, I have sent you as a light. You are a light that have been sent to deliver those that are still in the darkness. You are a light. So as an ambassador, you are a light. This is the mystery of the gospel. How do you deliver? Go ye out there. Tell them. Preach Jesus to them. They hear, like I said, let them be saved. They doubt, oh, is on the, they are on their own. But me, you, let us first of all fulfill what Lord have, Jesus have asked us to do. Let us fulfill it. So even if you are, you just decide to become, oh, let me just go to church on Sunday and dance, but you still have a mission. You are still on a mission. You are still on a duty. So that is why I said, as a Christian, your own is not just to go to church every Sunday, to just bobo, Jesu, akamara makangabo, jio. There is a mission that we are in for. We are in for a mission. We are in for a mission. So your own is to deliver, execute it, and leave the rest. Who doubt you, Naisabi? But let your spirit, if your spirit of a truth, bear witness that you are a child of God. Whosoever is not doubting you, leave that person to doubt. I love the Bible so much that we always say, he that has ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying. Like I said, the word of God is a two-edged sword. Even as I'm preaching it tonight, it's coming back to me. That is the gospel. As I'm saying it tonight, it's coming back to me as well. So the area where I know that I still have witness, I better still try to amend it. So it's not all about preaching it, it's all about doing it. That is what I keep telling people. The Acts 13:47. So God have already commanded us again that he has set us as a light. So we must not associate with darkness. You don't have business with them. Let them go. But you must come down to their level in order for you to be able to win them. Now, when the Gentiles heard this, they were glad. How beautiful it was. When the Gentiles heard it, they were glad and glorify the word of God, and as many that has been appointed to external life, they believed, and the word of the Lord was being spread throughout all the region. You see it? I keep telling people, the word of God, we can never dilute it. You can never dilute the word of God. So that is why you see a lot of churches today, they are having problems. By the time you miss the word of God, you miss him. You don't want to preach what the people want to hear. There will be a lot of problems in such a congregation. Give them the genuine word of God. Let it stroke their heart. Preach it today. Preach it tomorrow. And I've come to see sometimes a lot of preachers, maybe because you preach salvation today and the whole atmosphere is calm. They are not happy. There is no ride on. After preaching salvation today, the next week you will just come and ginger them again. And ginger them. That salvation you are preaching, you are removing it out of them. Preach salvation today. Preach preach it tomorrow, preach it next tomorrow. The Bible says Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever and evermore. The word of God is unchanged. We cannot change it. It's what is yea and amen. So this is the more reason. Our own, deliver it. Who want to that, make it that. It not consign me again. You believe, oh, it's good for you. You doubt, oh, it's good for you. Anyhow, so may God give us the grace to do what God have asked us to do for him in the name of Jesus. And a lot of us, the grace is available. It's just for you to wake up and make use of it. That's all. The grace is already available. He has been giving us. Though we still need sufficient to be able to end well. But the grace is available for everybody. The grace is available for everyone. That is why you have been called. Make use of it. Let's make use of this grace. Make use of this grace so that God forbid disgrace at the end. Make use of the grace of God positively so that God forbid disgrace at the end in hellfire. In hellfire. So let's also see Acts of Apostles 20:24. You know, messages like this don't entice people. So he that has here, let him hear. Like I said, my platform is not a platform of come and kill and die. Yes, so when it's time for welfare, go for welfare. When it's time for you to hear the genuine message, hear it. This is the only thing that will set us free. The truth, the gospel. The truth, the gospel. And if you have the truth, you have the gospel. And you wage war spiritually, God will be able to help you to settle those cases. You see, settle it one after the other for you. You go begin, they settle and they go. You are a light. So you don't have any business with darkness. That is it. Now, like I said, Acts of Apostles chapter 20 verse 24. These are scriptures for us. Acts 20, 24. But none of these things move me. Nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may be able to finish my race with joy, the ministry which I have received from the Lord Jesus, to testify to the gospel of the grace of God. That I count myself. I don't even take myself again. I don't even see me myself. I don't even see myself as anything again. This was Apostle Paul talking. The Bible says, when we try to save our life, we will lose it. When you try to protect your name, you don't want problem, you will lose it. But when you say, oh, for the sake of God, let anything happen, God will protect you. Yes. A lot of us today, we are running so that people will not call you I-Service. When you know that you are not doing I-2-No, or you are not doing I-Service, or you are not doing showcase thing, why must you run? Why must you run? I keep telling people, when you are real, you are real. When you are fake, you are fake. You will know by yourself if you are real. You will know by yourself when you are fake. I remember when I was starting, maybe a lot of people were saying, ah, what is she up to? 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 By the special grace of God, it will soon be a year now. It will soon be, I'm counting, and that day I'm going to celebrate that 1 year, whether the devil likes it or not. Because I never ever expected I would do Wednesday. I know that always my Wednesday is choked up. I came back from church, was it not after 10 years? I went for Bible study and dig it deep. I came back after 10, I am still here. Have I not had a wonderful moment with God? Yes. I have a beautiful time in the presence of God already. So, but I never ever expected it that I would be able to face camera like this. And maybe when I was starting, I know a lot of people. And I know a lot of things that I have faced since I've been on it. But Apostle Paul says, brethren, I count not myself as anything any longer. I don't take it as anything. That is Acts of Apostles chapter 20, Acts 20, 24. The Bible says, but none of these things move me again. None of these things move me. Nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may be able to finish my race with joy. And the ministry which I have received from the Lord Jesus, so testify to the gospel of the grace of God. So the only ministry we have received from Jesus is to preach the gospel. Is to preach the gospel. We are now living testimonies of him, declaring him, proclaiming him to the Gentiles, to those that have not known him, to those that have not still believed that Jesus is Lord. What are you testifying today? What are you testifying? What are you doing as an ambassador of Christ? This is another thing I'm leaving for you to answer as a child of God. What are you doing? What are you doing for the Lord? How many souls have you winned? How many? The kingdom of God is all about soul winning. I keep telling people, God did not just call you in order for you to fight for yourself, but he called you in order for you to be able to save others. But don't save others and leave yourself. Try to make sure that is where they work out your own salvation. But you have to be very, very much careful even in the process of trying to save other people. You need to be prayerful. You need to have the word of God so that those people you think that you want to save will not be the people that will save you. Will not be the people that will not pull you to their own clue. So we need to work it out, and you need to balance your, ask God to help you to balance your spiritual life. So let none of these things move you any longer. Whatever they want to say, let them say. Whatever they want to talk, let them talk. Even if they want to doubt, let them doubt. Let it not move you again. Let the only thing that moves you now in this end time, let it be the ministry that you have received from Jesus to testify the gospel of grace to God in order for people to be saved, in order for the kingdom of darkness not to be able to prevail over light, in order for the devil not to win. Yes, he's still going to win those that allow him to win them. But for me and you, we must try our possible best to see that these powers of darkness, powers of manipulations, powers of deception, powers of falsehood, at least let God filter a lot of them. So like I said earlier on, a lot of them, disgrace and shame is waiting for them this year, 2020. Except they repent, oh, is of two ways. Except they repent. That is why you and I, we have been called. Preach it to them, except they repent. They receive Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior, or rather they follow their master, the devil, and they will go and perish in the kingdom of, in air fire, in the lake of fire, whether they like it or not. Whether they like it or not. Matthew chapter 5, verse 15 to 16. Let's see what the Bible says. And a lot of people, we are still afraid. Matthew 5, 15 to 16. Matthew 5, 15 to 16. So I keep telling people, it's our time that you make your territory to become a danger zone for the devil. Make it danger. Don't make it to be comfortable for them any longer. Matthew chapter, I think I said the book of Matthew 5, 15 to 16. Hallelujah, somebody. God bless you all, even for those that are still online. Matthew 5, 15 to 16. The Bible says, nor do they light a light. Nor do they light a light and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all those who are in the house. We carry the presence of God. So as an ambassador of God, you carry light. You carry the presence of God. Anywhere there is darkness, immediately you enter there, your torch is supposed to shine in order for those people to see that, eh, I see you in a day darkness. Not that you will say you are a child of God. You will still go to a place that there is darkness. Before you know it, you still enter. We are. That is why I said a lot of them no longer have respect for men and women of God today. They will now say, hey, you see, that is why you see a lot of them, they respect the fake more than the original. Yes. What we see in our world today, people have respect for fake anointing and fake powers more than the original. Like I will always say, the fake anointing are not the most expensive one. But the real one, we call them cheap grace, cheap anointing. Eh? And the fake ones are the ones deceiving people. Because why? They will tell you that, this thing that you are doing, you want to go and see a man of God, for instance, you will be afraid. Maybe this, because why? You see and say, that man of God, they see vision. You understand? But this is what is actually happening in Christianity today, which supposed not to be. But when we that call ourselves Christians, that really call ourselves genuine ones, but when we no longer mingle with or associate ourselves with these people that are, even they themselves, they will know that we have already known them. They will know that we have known the kind of people that they are. They will know that we no longer have business with them. You don't already know who the person be. You don't know who the person be. Like I said, you can wave out from a distance, or you begin to watch from afar off. The Bible says with our eyes, we will behold and see the reward. We must see their end. They will not see our end in the name of Jesus. The Bible says with our eyes, we will behold and see the reward of the wicked. This is the scripture for us. It is we that will see their end. They don't have any right to see our end. We will see their end. Even if they think we are not seeing their end today, but one day, they will end up in fire. Because the Bible says, except they repent, or else on that day is going to tell a lot of them, get out from here, go away, I don't know you. Hey, I have prophesied your name. Hey, I was healing in your name. Everybody is calling the name of Jesus, 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 Jesus. On that day, we are going to know who is who. So it's our time, like I said, do not allow the devil to deceive you any longer. Because immediately the devil deceive you, meaning the devil will be able to win you to his own side. You are not his friend. I am not his friend. We are the friend of God. We are no longer slave to fear. We are no longer slave to fear. Why? Before an ambassador will leave his country, you leave Nigeria to Spain to say, I want to come and represent Nigeria. Yeah, for instance, in Spain. or rather, maybe it depends on your country. At least I'm trying to use the Spanish and Nigeria embassy as a case study tonight. Before any of the ambassador will leave Nigeria to Spain, the man ready now. He ready? Or rather the woman or whatsoever. He is prepared. So we must be prepared. Don't allow them to deceive you any longer. Because by the time you allow them to deceive you, they have been able to win you to their side. Because why? They feel that you are not seeing them. You don't know them. You don't know who they are. Eh? You don't know who they are. So this is the Bible for us. I read from Matthew 5, 15 to 16. That is where I was reading. So the Bible says, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all those who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good work and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let your light so shine. And who is this light? Jesus. Jesus is the light. He's the light of the world. He's the light of the world. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was with God. Let me go there. I love that book of Genesis so much. For you to understand me better, what I'm trying to say, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. I keep telling us, even God himself was not able to start creation without light. Even God himself was unable to create without light. So you cannot expect to be in darkness and you want to see anything that is in the light. You will not be able to save anybody, because a blind man can never lead a blind man. It is only a man that sees that can lead a blind man. Yes. Even God himself was unable to create, even in the midst of darkness. The Bible says the Spirit of God, hallelujah, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. The Spirit of God was roaming around. Where do I start from? How do I begin? Where do I start from? How do I begin? But the Bible made you understand, until God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. This is to tell you and I that there is nothing good in darkness. So as an ambassador of God, you are a light carrier. And the light carrier, you are the presence, you are a presence carrier. You carry the gospel. You carry Jesus. You carry the word of God. So you must have to declare it to the world. Fear not. You have been sent. Go. He said, go ye out there. I will finish that book of Matthew 15. So we don't have business with darkness. There is nothing good in darkness. Are you still a man or a woman? You still think that you are in the dark? Come to light and see Jesus. Come and see the light. The light of God. Come and see the light. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Jesus is the light. The light of God. Jesus is the light. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. When we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory shines on our way. When we do his good will, he abides with us still. And to those who we trust and obey. So that is just as simple as that. There is nothing good in darkness. So are you still in the dark? Come to light now. Or else that he said, or else that darkness, the gross darkness, it will swallow you someday. But my prayer is that, are you hearing me now or you hear me later? If you are not yet saved, accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. He does not want any soul to perish. But if you are already in Jesus, do not allow the devil to win you to his side. Because the devil does not even want a lot of us that are already in Christ Jesus to make it. He does not want you and I to make it. That is why you see, the devil is not tired though. Somebody. A lot of us, we are tired in the place of prayer. A lot of us, we are tired in working for God. A lot of us, we are tired in getting busy for the Lord. Whereas the devil every day by day is not tired. The Bible says he's walking to and fro looking for whom to devour. May the devil not devour you. May the devil not devour me. And who is this devil? The devil is not that man that wear black and black. The devil is, like the Bible says, they are principalities and powers. The devil, like I keep saying, he walks through vessels. He walks through humans. He walks through people that have given their life to him for destruction. But my brother, my sister, do not give yourself to the devil to destroy. So for you that have already seen the light, you have, even if you have not really seen him, but at least you have seen the glimpse, the touch light at all, allow him to touch you completely and surrender all to God. This is a word for somebody tonight. This message might not be a message that will interest everybody. Like I will always say, I am not here to preach in order for people to be, how will I put it? I am not here to preach the word of God in order for me to interest people. I am here to tell you the truth. The truth, like I always tell us, is a two-edged sword. You know Jesus now, or you go or you know the devil, choose. Let even God himself, let him know your stand. Even God himself, let him know where you are standing now, although he is the one that knows our beginning to the end. He knows our beginning to the end, somebody. So that is the word of God. If God can see, when he created the light, he said, wow, light is good. God himself declared it. He saw it that light was good before the creation. If God could not create anything out of darkness, then how do you not think that people that are even making it out of darkness, they think that they make it out of darkness, or they do all manners of evil out of darkness, and they think it's going to last forever. It will only last for some time. It will not last forever. So there is nothing somebody gets from darkness that will last forever. Now, let me finish that book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 15 to 16. Like the Bible says, Matthew 5, 15 to 16. And glorify your Father which is in heaven. Okay, that is, I've read it before. From verse 13. Verse 13 says, ye are the salt of the earth. But if the salt lost its flavor, how shall it then be seasoned? A lot of us today that call ourselves Christian, ambassadors of Christ, representative, we've lost our taste. A lot are walking in their past glory. A lot are walking in their past glory. But let's remember, he said, if you have lost your favor, your flavor or whatsoever, you can no longer season life. You can no longer say, but you can still do it. If you receive Jesus now as your Lord and personal Savior, and you don't allow your past to hold you down. You did not allow your past to hold you down. Now, let's see Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20. I'm talking about the gospel. Matthew 28, 19 to 20. Let's see what the Bible says. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go ye therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the what? Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all the things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. So why must you be afraid? Even when God has said, I am with you, I back you up. Do you know what it means when Jesus, this is God himself telling you, my son, my daughter, do not be afraid. I have not given you the spirit of fear. Go, now me send you. Go, now me back you up. Then you are afraid. You are afraid. Afraid of what? Child of God, do not be fear. In fact, be fearless. Be fearless. Your father is the lion of the tribe of Judah. The only man that goes to battle and he will not return back defeated. Then you are afraid. He has said to you, why do we call him Jehovah the mighty man of war? Why do we call him Jehovah the mighty man in battle? Why? He's mighty warrior. Great in battle. That is the God that I've sent you on an errand. He said, go. Go, declare it to them. Preach it to them. Preach it to them. They hear. Well, if they hear, let them be saved. If they don't hear, they will be destroyed. They will be condemned. So this is the gospel. This is the gospel. This is the work of an ambassador. So it takes a lot. Christianity is far more beyond what a lot of us are seeing it to be today. Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Luke 4, verse 18. Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Let's see what the Bible says in Luke 4, 18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. Hey, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive and the recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel, the mystery of the gospel. This is a time we need to unlock the mystery of the gospel. So like I said, in our world today, a lot of Christians are relenting. We are resting before time. It's not yet time for us to rest. The only time that we'll feel at home, the only time we will rest, the only time a man will rest, that is if you die, if such a man or such a woman died in Christ Jesus, then you will rest with him in glory. But there are a lot of people, whether if you like, write 10,000 recipes, in their obituary picture, they will never rest in peace. Because why? They did not die in Christ Jesus. So the only time you and I are permitted to rest is when we get home, is when we see him face to face, is when we, yay, good and faithful servant, well done. Is when your work has been tested, is when your work has passed through the examination and you pass. That is the only time you can rest. So it's not yet time to rest. As ambassadors of Christ, people of God, chosen generation, peculiar people, royal priesthood, prince and queens, children of the Most High God, I have come to let us know that this is not a time for us to rest. It's our time for us to make the kingdom of darkness. Let us make as many of them. Like I keep telling people, your spirit will, if you are a genuine child of God, you must, your spirit will tell you of a truth. Like me, I know how to follow. But in fact, that does not mean I don't know. But my own is that, who are you following? Who are you following is another question. It's our time. We need to disconnect so that we will be able to preach the truth. Because when you are still in their midst, you will not be able to speak the truth. Because why? You are in darkness and you want to rebuke darkness. Darkness can never rebuke darkness. It's impossible. Let's tell ourselves the truth. Darkness can never win over darkness. The only thing that can win over darkness is light. But it's a pity today that a lot of people, darkness is triumphing over them. Spiritual life, physical, the devil is just making them to be busy. Busy. But yet, the devil knows what he's doing. The devil is helping a lot of Christians today to lose more focus. He is getting them distracted. That is exactly what he wanted to do to Jesus. But Jesus refused to bow. Jesus refused to bow. And he refused to bow because of the spoken word. It is written. It is written. It is written. Child of God, I draw my conclusion that he who has ears, let him hear. The devil is a very wicked man. The devil is a very wicked man, eh? The devil is not somebody that, like I said, you can joke with. It's not somebody that, like I said, we can joke with. So we should always have the book of Ephesians chapter 12 at the back of our mind. Always have it at the back of your mind for you to know that you are in a war front. You are in a battlefield. It's not yet time for us to rest. The only time for us to rest is when we get to meet Jesus. The only time for us to rest is when we hear the sound of the trumpet. But a lot of people did not even hear the sound of the trumpet today. They are gone. They are in under the 6 feet. A lot of them have decayed. But only God knows where their soul is now as I am talking to you. So child of God, I beg us that it's our time that we take up the whole armor of God, that we may be able to withstand in these evil days. Have it done unto stand. Stand therefore, having gird your waist with truth. Like the truth I'm talking about is Jesus. You must, before you think you want to stand and wage war, you must first of all know Jesus. Having gird your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, holiness. Because why? These are criteria that you are truly a child of God. That you are truly a child of God. Stand therefore, guard your waist with truth. Then put on the breastplate of righteousness, because Jesus is righteousness. Jesus is holiness. Jesus is sanctification. These are the mystery. These are the mystery. Now, above all, taking the shield of faith. I talked about faith before. You can see it again. So as an ambassador, you take up the shield of faith. The Bible says, with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Because when you have that, you take up that shield of faith, you will be fearless. You will not be afraid of their faces. Mm-mm. Eh? You will be always ready for war. You will be so troublesome for Christ. You will become a like I say, if there's anything they call radicalism in Christ Jesus. Because why? Because of the faith that you have. He said, I am not the one that have sent myself. And actually, we are not the one that have sent ourselves. So if you know that you are not the one that have sent yourself, then why do you fear? Why are you afraid of their faces? Why are we afraid as Christians? So the Bible says, take up the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. I've said all these things before. They're praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Be watchful. Be watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints, and for me that the utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. So be bold. Boldness. Be fearless. Anyhow it comes, be ready to face it. And you are not facing it alone, but God is your backup, because he said, go, and lo, I will be with you, even unto the end. He said to them in the book of Acts of Apostles, he said, go ye out there, preach the gospel, preach it to all living creatures, the mystery of the gospel. Preach it to them. This is Jesus himself. He said to them, go, I have given you that power, just go, preach it to them, even unto the uttermost part of the earth. To the uttermost part of the earth. Go ye out there, declare it to them. So my own is that, he who has ears, let him hear. The Bible says, he who hears is baptized and is saved. Meaning you are meant for what? You are not meant for destruction. You are not meant for condemnation. But when you hear, you refuse and you still decide. Like I said, on that day, God is, none of us, is no, nobody is going to tell God, is one man of God or one woman of God that deceived me. That is why I did not live a life that you have asked me to live. No. Everybody is going to bear account. You will bear your own. I will bear my own. That is the more reason you must do what God has asked you to do. And do not allow anybody to deceive you. Run with God. Run with the word of God. I keep telling people, study to show yourself approved unto God. So there is no ministry without the word of God. You have been sent on an errand. And without the word of God, there is no way you can deliver that which you have been sent to those that you have been sent to. God has sent me. God has sent you. God has sent every one of us. So it's our time. And this is the time. This is the time that we must go out there to fish for the Lord. This is the time that you and I must go out there and get it done. The king's haste, the king's business requires haste. Let us hasten it up. Let us hasten it up so that God forbid more disaster than this. It's time for us to hasten it up. So let us wake up and take our place. Wake up, take your place of duty. Wake up, take your place. Don't allow anybody to take your place in the kingdom. I refuse to allow anybody to take my place. And I pray it for somebody tonight. May you never allow anybody to take your place in the name of Jesus. So may just join me and let us reference God. That is just all I want to say. Now, I already gave us the definition of an ambassador and what it takes to become an ambassador. What it takes to become an ambassador. So if you are just joining now, you can watch the video again. Like I said, we are in here for a mission. And with that mission, now it requires haste. It requires haste. So gone are the days. Nobody will say, I die. No, I never hear. We don't hear. We are seeing it already. The word of God is coming to fulfillment every day. So the king's business requires haste. In fact, let us be able to save as many will be able to. Do your part and let me do my part. But all to the glory of God. All to the glory of God. That is why I keep telling a lot of people, a true man of God, or rather a true woman of God, we always want to support the gospel to make sure that a lot of lives are saved. A lot of lives are saved. Because it's all about our Father's business. It is only those that takes it to be their business. They take it to be because of selfishness, greediness. Because they want to work for their belly. That is when they will see truth. They will not want to support. Because they don't want the people to know the truth. Let's tell ourselves this truth. Why? They want to feed their belly. It's like you are spoiling their business. It's like you are running their business down. You are closing their business center. You don't want them to eat any longer. You don't want them to feed any longer. It is only those kind of people. They will be angry of you. They will be so angry. Why are you spoiling this business for us? But child of God, you are not spoiling any business for them. But rather, you are trying to let the devil know that he cannot win this battle. We are on a battle. The light, the kingdom of light and darkness, they are battling it. So it is an error for any genuine child of God that I'll say, oh, I have known Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior. You will not still allow them to just cohabit you and just win you to their side. Eh? Stop running to them, oh child of God. Like I said, be wise. Be wise. The days are evil. Let us not be ignorant of their devices. Let your signal, your antenna, let it be opened. Let it be opened 247. Don't disconnect yourself any longer. Reconnect yourself back to God and fall back to your place of duty. May God empower us and give us the grace to be able to run this race to the end in the name of Jesus. Let's just lift up our voice and thank God that in any area we have been falling short of his glory. The book of Romans says, for all we have seen are fall short of the glory of God. The glory only departed. Why? Because of sin. But the Bible still made us to understand that the time of refreshing will come when we repent genuinely. Like I said, each and every one of us, we have our little weakness. But you know it, and you are still praying that. Apostle Paul said, the things I don't want to do, I still see myself doing them. You know it, and you are still asking God that, oh, Father, help me. There is a prayer I normally used to pray. I would say, oh, Father, every weakness in me, exchange it with your strength. By strength, we cannot prevail. By our own strength, we can never, ever prevail. The word of God says, woman of God, Mama Betty, God bless you. Thank you for joining, Mama. God bless you, Ma. That is the Bible for us. By strength, we cannot prevail. Queen Lily, God bless every one of you. Thank you. Thank you for your compliment. You know, like this, when you are on the live video, you have to be very careful of some comments. That is why I always want to go through the live video after I finish. I might tell you that sometimes I don't even see when a lot of people join, but later I see your comment, and I really appreciate every one of you for always coming around to listen to what this little girl have to say. I am not here because I just want to be here. At least to talk sometimes for 30 minutes, 1 hour, and at the end of it all, I don't have a church on my own. I don't have a church that I establish on my own. No, I'm just only privileged to do this for God. It's just a privilege. I don't take it for granted. And I'm not even intending tomorrow, because to become a pastor's wife, you know, not easy. According to Benin people, not be easy task. It's not all about carrying the name. It's all about the responsibility. If we really know what genuine men and women of God face, we will pity them. Like, seriously. If we know what genuine men and women of God face, it's not easy to run a ministry. It's not easy. So I'm not even intending. The little I can do, let me do. This is just why I am here. So it's not that sometimes, even myself, if I say it's easy, it's not that easy. You talk for 30 minutes, 1 hour, or 2 hours. Is it an easy task? It's not an easy task. But my prayer is that, Father, may my work not be in vain. Help me, whatever. Help me that my work will not be in vain. It will not be good at all. That is what Apostle Paul said. After preaching Christ to the world, and have faith to do his will. The Bible says, woe unto such a man or such a woman. So in any area, that is why I keep praying, Father, help me, oh, I cannot help myself. That is why I keep telling people, don't think that you know it too much. The Bible says, let him that thinketh he stand, watch it. You that think you are standing. That is why me, all these people that are sanctimonious, holy, holy, let him that thinketh he stand, watch, lest he will fall. By strength, no man can prevail. I am talking like this today. It's just the grace of God. By strength, no man can prevail. I don't even have it all. What do I know to say? What do I know? Where will I start from? So, when it comes to the things of God, when you humble yourself, God will use you. I keep telling people, God is not looking for people that have known it all. He's still out there searching, looking for that one man, that one girl, that one boy that will say, oh, Father, here I am. What do I know? I gave us an example of Gideon sometimes ago. I gave us an example of Moses sometimes ago. God is still looking for babies, children. He's not looking for adults that will say, hey, I'm already cracking bone. I don't even want to hear anything again. What do you have to tell me? What do you have to say? God is not looking for those kind of people. I'm that kind of a child. I am still learning. I'm still a baby. I am still learning. I keep telling people, when you watch my live video, you see any error, call my attention to it instantly. Ah, Star Rachel, this thing you said, all those minister title, I don't always like it. You rather call me sister or call me Rachel. I make heaven that I will just carry one big title, Minister Rachel. And at the end of it all, God forbid, are you a minister of light or you're a minister of darkness? Where do you belong to? We have different pastors. We have different prophetess. We have different prophets. We have apostles. We have evangelists. We have teachers. We have ministers. But which one do you belong to? Which group? Which one are you representing? Are you an ambassador of light or you are an ambassador of darkness? These are questions we're supposed to be asking ourselves. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man sow, that will he reap. So let's just appreciate God. And I keep on saying, in your time of closet, remember me in prayers. Yes. Remember me, because sometimes I will not really say it's easy. It's the grace of God. May his grace also be sufficient for every one of us to carry this cross and follow Jesus. You see a lot of flashy things. Things that you love, but you go throw away. Is it not flashy? It is flashy. But don't let it flash you and flash you and flash you and flash you out of Christ. That is where the thing is bad. You see a lot of trials, temptation. People that are not even up to, they talk to you, they do all manner of things, all for the sake of the kingdom. And that is why you must not give up. Yes, Jesus did it for you. He did it for me. So we must do it for him as well. He did it for us. Now is the time. What are we doing for him? Because of us, he was bruised. Because of us, they spat on him. Because of us, they war in tongues. Because of us, they did all manner of evil to him. Like I said, before he screamed, Elohim lama sabachthani, do you know the agony that he has gone through? Eh? So there is a time in your life that you will look up to. That is why I keep telling people, don't say my voice is too loud. It was when Jesus screamed, Elohim lama sabachthani. It was a shout. And the Bible says, immediately he screamed. He said, hey, Father, Father, why are thou forsaking me? The curtain veil got torn and he declared, it is what? Finished. So this is the time that we need to shout. The voice of John the Baptist was heard in the wilderness. The voice of Zacchaeus was heard on a sycamore tree. And even Jesus, it was when he screamed, Father, why are thou forsaking me? Elohim lama sabachthani. And the Bible says, he declared, hey, it is finished. It was the voice. So that is why I keep saying God is still looking for that, all those righteous voice that will raise up their banner and say, hey, enough is enough. A lot of people are still under the bondage. They are still under bondage. Sometimes when I see some congregation, I will say, Jesus, you just that is to say, hey, all these people, they are just in darkness. I shared a video on my timeline day before yesterday. You saw a man of God playing football. The house of God have become a house that they gamble with. This is the thing that Jesus saw, and he entered into the temple and he scattered everything. In my father, you not want to make my father's house a den of thieves. This is what we are seeing today as well. This is what we are seeing. He scattered it before. So my prayer is that the king's business requires haste. We are in a world, because when the thing is happening, a lot of us now, we are in Europe. Even maybe, God forbid, coronavirus, it will not come near us. If you hear that, we hear it now that coronavirus is in Nigeria. But before you know it now, we are interceding for Nigeria again. Are we not carrying the whole cross together? Everybody is praying now. It's praying. Everybody is praying. But we forgot that the Bible says, if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and bow, then I will hear from heaven and heal the land. This is the time that we need to humble ourselves. And how do we humble ourselves? We humble ourselves in the place of prayer. We humble ourselves to speak the truth. We humble ourselves to speak righteousness. We humble ourselves to speak holiness. Let men and women desist from their wickedness. Repent from their wickedness or you die. Repent of your sin or you perish. Repent of your evil or you go. You go with the devil, your father. Because the Bible says the devil is the father of lies, liars, manipulators. Repent or you go. Repent or you die. Now, what did the Bible talk with that one? Yes. So this is not the time we are preaching it as if maybe you are begging people to serve God. You serve God is for your own good. You don't serve God, it's still for your own good. You serve God is for your own good. You don't still serve God. That is why I pity a lot of people that will say, I'm not going to serve God again. You don't serve God again, you are on your own. He decided, not that you were even qualified, not that we were qualified. He chose us. Not that we merit it, not that we qualified for it, but he decided to pick us out. And still, a lot of us, we are still failing our duty. People of God, this is the time that we need to raise up our voice and say, Father, now we want to see your hand. We want to see your power. We want to see your power manifest in, manifest it. Enough of this. There is a video I'm going to share by this. I remember that when I was in Nigeria. And Mama Margaret Agbonifo, that she sent all mothers for Nigeria to become a better place, that we mothers must keep on crying and shouting until Nigeria become praise. I received that video the first day on WhatsApp. I will share it with us. So if the world will become how will I put it? At least let God by himself fit out those that wickedness. Sorry to say, I'm on my live video. Even when I heard that they said coronavirus is in Nigeria, the first thing that entered my mind, I say, hey, Father, if this virus can just go to Aso Rock. That was the first thing that entered my mind. I said, may the innocent ones, may the righteous not suffer for what they don't know. That is my prayer. Because the Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, they are safe. That is the word of God for us. See, he said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God. That is the Bible for us. And the Bible says, the scripture says, for Zion's sake, I am not going to rest. For our sake, God says he will not rest. So when I heard that this virus just entered Nigeria, I said, oh, Father, may it locate them in Aso Rock. By the time I come up for Aso Rock, it fitter. May it locate them in Boko Haram camp. By the time I fitter, may it locate them in Fulani herbs. These are the places that we're supposed to begin to send this virus to, so that the land will be at peace. But take a look at it. You saw those little children that were singing coronavirus, go back to China. If I tell you that none of their child is there, do you think that any of those rich men or rich women, you will see their child walk on the street like that? They will sue the school for it. They will sue the teachers for it. They will sue the teachers for it. But just take a look at those little children. When I look at those children, I laughed. So we need to pray more. Now is the time. Now is the time, people of God. So God bless you all for joining me always. It's just like I said, it's not all about my business. I'm not even intending to plant, even if they say they want to go, they want to come and plant Redeemed Christian Church, I will be the last person, not be me. Because like I said, to become a leader of a ministry is not easy. We keep telling people, if the pastor is joining faith with the congregation to fight, to cast one demon, God forbid, we know, you might not really know what genuine men and women of God they face. We might not really know. They face a lot. So it's not easy to run a ministry. That is why I keep telling people, learn to show respect on your man or woman of God. Don't look down on them. So long you even say, okay, let me worship in this parish. Let me worship in this church. So long your spirit, let me worship under this parish. Respect them. It's not easy to lead. They might be having their own weakness. They might be having their own fault. There come a time in the life of Moses that the Amalekites, they were always prevailing and winning. We are always prevailing. Hell and all, they were able to raise up the hand of Moses. Two people lifted up his hands. That was when he was able to prevail. That was where. So sometimes the genuine ones, they need our hands. And I keep telling people, it's even much more better, sorry to say this one. If maybe I even rather better to so much all ends with my man of God or my pastor or the wife to pray than running after the ones. I don't even know where they get their powers from. I'm giving us a word now. But sometimes it's good for you to design them before you follow. Don't just follow because you see them having crowd. Don't just follow because you see them say, Thus says the Lord. The spirit of the blasphemy is what God can never forgive. Don't run after them because you just see them say, Thus says the Lord, when the Lord have not spoken. A lot of them, they don't even know the God that they are saying, Thus says the Lord. So if you are in, I'm telling you now, if you worship under any parish or under any auditorium, it's far more better you respect your man or woman of God. Respect them. It's not easy. It's not easy. So I'm not here because I have seen a lot of people, they start life like this before you know they go open church. No, it's not in my dictionary and it's not even in my agenda or diary. But the little I'll be able to do for my Father is what I am doing. Because he said, go ye out there, preach the gospel of truth to them, unlock the mystery to them. I was afraid. At the initial state, I was afraid because I once criticized people that are doing it. Yes, must you come out on social media before they will know that you are a minister? Must you come out on social media before they will know that you are a Christian? No. I keep on telling us, I'd rather prefer to use my Facebook page to do business than this. Because it's not like a God. Like I keep telling people, it's not all about showcasing things. Not all about showcasing things. But thank God I could not hide from it. But social media is also a place you can use for good evangelism. Because even the Bible, the word of God made us to understand that knowledge will increase. Knowledge, he said, it will increase. Technology increased. So you can use your platform for anything. But may God give us the spirit of boldness to do it for him without fear, without fear of favor. Speak the word of God. Go ye out there. Declare it. for those that is to those that will hear, the Bible says they will be saved. And for those that refuse to hear, they will be met for condemnation. I keep telling us the story of the Lazarus and the rich man. What happened in Abraham's bosom when the rich man was like saying, Father Abraham, I still have a lot of them out there. They will only believe if somebody from the dead go to them. But the Bible says, God said, hey, if they refuse to believe, they have people out there. In fact, let me look at those that are still watching. Let me mention your names one by one. The Bible says, he said to them, hey, they have Mama Iyesogie there. Mama Happy Best is there. Mama Susan Aga is there. Mama Joy Oseni is there. Eh? Mama Osayowe is there. Mama Joy is there. Mama Happy is there. Mama Gift. Mama Gift Joy Enabulele is there. Eh? Mama Jessica is there. Mama Tracy is there. I'm just trying to mention the names of people that are watching now. You understand? So, this was exactly what happened. They are there. If they refuse to hear, they will come here again and suffer what you are suffering. So, may God help us all in the name of Jesus. And my prayer is that may we never depart away from the truth. Because any man or woman that departs away from the truth, automatically you are departing already, or rather deviating already from Jesus. So may we not depart away from truth. May God give us the grace to stand and face with boldness, with truth, in fact, don't allow anybody to humiliate you. Because why? You know of a truth. You're in Christ Jesus. Speak the truth to them. Oh, he who has ears, let him hear. God bless you all. I just want you to join me. And let's appreciate God. And let's still pray that as many that have not yet known Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior, that God will give them the grace to be able to know him more. As many that have not known him as his Lord, as their Lord and personal Savior, that God will save as many of them. Even as many of them that are still in their bondage, eh? In the bondage of fake pastors, fake prophets, fake prophetess. This is the time for us to even pray that God, we help, we open their eyes. We open their eyes to see that they are in darkness. Because why? The Bible says God does not want any soul to perish. So let us help in prayers as well. This time is the time that God needs to expose and disgrace. Expose and disgrace. Expose and disgrace those that are using his name in vain. Those that are saying, thus says the Lord, thus says the Lord. When the Lord God have not said anything, thus says. It is not the Lord that has said. It is their Ishango. It is their sea goddess. It is their man-made God. It is their Oloku. It is their Ogbanje Oloku. Ogbanje spirit, Oloku spirit, water spirit, the useless spirit that they are walking, that have not even saw. Although maybe they are hearing that thought said from those spirits, but it's not really from the spirit of God. But my prayer is that may God deliver as many that are still in the bondage of every foul spirit that is not of God. May God deliver as many that are still in the bondage of darkness. May God deliver as many that are still in the bondage of false prophets, false prophetess, false pastors, false ministers, false evangelists, false preachers, false teachers, in the name above every other name. May God deliver each and every one of them. May God expose and disgrace as many that are using his name in vain. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name above every other name. In fact, this time around, the word of God will be so hot. Will be so hot for them that they will not be able to manipulate people. Even as many that are still manipulating, may God by himself visit them. Visit them in this season. That is my prayer for them. God will visit them one by one. One by one, whether they like it or not. And if they try to even escape it, on that last day, they will not be able to escape it. In the name of Jesus. This is my prayer in this season. May God by himself deliver his children. Just the way he delivered the children of Israelites from the hands of the Egyptian. May God by himself deliver his people. This is the time. But my own is that when God is speaking, be ready to hear. Because a lot of us, even when God is speaking, it's like God is not speaking. Yes. A lot of people have hated me for this truth. I keep telling us, a lot of people have offended me for it. A lot of people have blocked me for it. And a lot of people are looking from far. They are watching from far. But truth is truth. Truth is truth. You can never hide the light. Because God himself is light. I have been hated. I have been blocked. A lot of people are still watching from far. But my own is that God is God. His word is yea and amen. And the gospel of truth must be preached. But those that will hear will be saved. Those that will not hear will be condemned. So enough of saying, I have been deceived, I have been manipulated. You have the word of God. Let nobody deceive you. And may God give us the grace to always hear when he's speaking in the name of Jesus. I just want to appreciate God for tonight. Father, I bless you for your word. Thank you for speaking to us again. And I ask that you keep on empowering us. We will not faint. We will not faint. You said, if we faint not, we will reap in due season. Father, I pray for every genuine man and woman of God. I pray for every genuine pastor. I pray for every genuine prophet. I pray for every genuine prophetess. I pray for every genuine apostle. I pray for every genuine evangelist. I pray for every genuine teachers. Father, that this time, give them the grace to be able to stand in a time like this. Give them the grace to be able to raise up their righteous voice for you. Father, whatever that is trying to take put them in the bondage of fear, Father, give them the voice to be able to rise up their voice for you in this end time, to speak your word in truth without fear of favor, without fear of favor, without favorable, in the name of Jesus. Father, empower them, oh God, to do more works for you. Give them the grace, oh God, to follow. Give them, Father, strengthen them. Empower every genuine minister, every genuine minister of your gospel. Empower them, Lord. Father, raise men, oh God. In this generation, we still need men like let Papa Bensi, Archbishop Idaosa. Father, we need more voices. Oh, Abba, Father, we need more voices. Men like Elijah, men like Elisha, men like Daniel, men like Paul, men like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Men and women, oh God. Women like Esther, women like Deborah. Women, oh God, that will be able to raise up their voices for you as well. We need more righteous voice. As many that declare your name, oh God, that declare your name in truth. Father, I ask for strength, extraordinary strength, that you will keep on strengthening them. You will keep on empowering them. Father, oh God, because this battle is of you, Lord. The battle is not our own. The battle is not our own. Empower every genuine minister, even on this Facebook, that when they preach, people will hear their voice. Every power that is trying to silence the voices of genuine ministers on this Facebook, Holy Ghost fire, that is my prayer. Every power that is trying to silence the voices of truth in this Facebook, Holy Ghost fire. But Lord, in social media, in whatever platform that they operate through, every power that is not of you, Father, let disgrace and shame be their portion in the name of Jesus. But those are ministers in their place of worship, in their churches, wherever they minister your word, Father, in genuinity, in truth and in spirit, not because they want to be self-centered, not for the sake of their belly. Father, I ask for extraordinary grace. Strengthen them. Lift them up in this time of battle that they will not fall. Lift them up in this time of this end time, that they will stand and declare your word in truth. They will refuse to fear, but give out your word the way it be. This is my prayer for every genuine minister in his Facebook. Wherever you stand to declare the gospel of truth, may God empower you. Because why? You are trying to fight. It is a war front. It is a battlefield. They will not win. We declare and we stand together. We join our forces together in this end time to say, darkness, we rebuke you. Darkness, you must bow. Darkness, give way and let the light of God prevail over the light of over the life of as many people that are still not saved. This is my prayer from every genuine pastor, for every genuine, for the fivefold ministry, for every son and daughter, for everyone that you have called, that you have said, go ye and declare your word. For as many, hey, that believed, you said to them, you have given the power to become sons and daughters of you, Lord. Father, empower these ones. Hey, empower these ones. They will know no shame. For every genuine minister of God, my prayer for you tonight is that you will know no shame. You will not be disappointed. God will not disappoint you. You will know no shame. You will know no shame. God will not disgrace you. May God continue to empower you to dish out the word of God in truth. But for those that are fake, you will know shame. Double portion of shame and disgrace will be your portion, because you have deceived a lot of people a lot. God have given power to the genuine ones to save. Instead of you to join to save, you are joining for condemnation. For the genuine ones, God will empower you, you will know no shame. For the fake ones, God will empower you, disgrace and shame will be your portion in the name of Jesus. This is my outcry tonight for somebody. It is not easy, but God will make it to be easy for us all. It is not easy. The battle we have is not a child's play, but God, because we have the backing, we have the backing of the Holy Ghost, we are going to prevail. We are going to win. They come to us in the dream. In any way they come, God will fight our battle. He will fight this battle and we will win, because he said, hey, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Salvation is the gospel. Hey, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. For the Egyptian you see today, you shall see them no more. So when you receive the gospel now is that stand still. The gospel now is that stand still. The gospel is that stand still. And you will see the salvation of the Lord. So until you see the salvation of the Lord, you cannot be saved. This is exactly what he said to the children of the Israelites. That was the word of God. That was the gospel. And I'm telling somebody tonight, are you genuine? Are you a pastor? Are you an apostle? Are you a preacher? Are you an evangelist? Are you a child of God? Are you a son of God? Are you a daughter of God? Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. For the Egyptian we see today, very soon we shall see them no more. He said in his word, fright not thyself because of the wicked. Be thou not averse for wrongdoers, for they shall soon fade like grass and wither like the green herbs. A lot of them think they are reigning. A lot of them think that nobody has known them. But God is exposing them one by one. So may God continue to empower as many that are declaring his name is truth. As many that does not have any other God under their bed. They don't have any other shrine in their pulpit. There are a lot of pulpits today. They have different kind of calabash. There are a lot of pulpits today. Different kind of heads are be buried. There are a lot of pulpits today. Different kind of sacrifice are be slain in those pulpits. But as many that only the sacrifice of the blood of Jesus is speaking through their pulpit, you will know no shame. You will know no disgrace. But if from your pulpit or any media or any form, you are trying to re-strategize yourself every day. You are trying to re-modernize yourself. You are trying to reform yourself. You are trying to recook yourself with the blood of animals, with the blood of humans, with the blood. You are trying to make sacrifice every day, using your money, using your energy, using your time to look for more sacrifice in order for you to get more, how will I put it, to get more people for you to deceive. You will be disgraced. Disgrace and shame will be your portion in the name of Jesus. Like I said, as many that the blood of Jesus is speaking through, you will never know shame. God will empower you. Your work will not be in vain. God will continue to help you. God will continue to add increase. Your ministry, souls will, in fact, it increment on every side. Fruitfulness on every side in the name of Jesus. But every ministry that is meant to deceive people for deception, for manipulation, for falsehood, even they want to make name for themselves, disgrace and shame will be your portion. That is my prayer for somebody tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, I just want to say thank you for your word. Thank you, Jesus, for how far you have been with me. For how far you've seen me through. For how far you've brought me through. And I know you are with me, Lord. And I know you will be with me until the end. It is your word. I am not afraid of their faces. Father, because I know, if you be for me, who can be against me? No one. I'd rather walk with you. Let me walk with you, Jesus, all the days of my life. May I not be found wanting, even at the time, when the set time. When you come, may I not be found wanting. May I not be found. Help me, Lord. In any area that I am weak, strengthen me, Lord. I need your grace, your sufficient grace. Give me the grace to be able to end well. And so also to as many ministers that preach your gospel in truth. We need your grace to end well. Apostle Paul says, I have fought the good fight of faith. I have finished my course. This will be our testimony in the name of Jesus. Father, I hide under the shadow of your wings. I hide under your canopy. I hide under the name of the Lord Jesus. I hide under your blood. The blood has speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. Have your way, Lord. May your name be glorified. And for as many that will even watch this video after now, may your word, O God, minister by yourself, minister to them. This time, Lord, by yourself, expose and disgrace the works of the wicked ones. Expose and disgrace the works of the powers of darkness. As many, I repeat my words, Lord, as many that does not have any other God under their bed, or rather they don't have any other shrine, as many that call on your name, Jesus, in truth and in spirit, Father, empower them in this end time, that they will keep speaking your truth without fear or favor in the name of Jesus. Father, you said you will be with us even until the end. We need you more. Strengthen us. Strengthen our faith in you daily, that we will not faint. We will not faint. We will not faint. We will not faint in the name of Jesus. Lord, I bless you. Give us the grace to take up our responsibilities as ambassadors in this land, in this earth, in this world, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Beloveds, I just want to say God bless you for staying till the end. My mama, woman of God, Mama Betty, Mama, God bless you. Oh, Mama Happy, Mama Susanna. Thank you, everyone, even for staying up to this time. Like I said, sometimes, Mama Joy Peter, wow, God bless everyone. Mama Stainless Light, oh my goodness, God bless you all that we are able to join me. Thank you. Like I said, you know, sometimes when you are on a mission and when the thing is getting hotter, you begin to see that people are watching you from distance. But let them begin to watch. Whosoever is watching from distance, let him watch. Or my Father's business. In fact, the name of the Lord. Whether in fact, the word of God, it must prevail just the way it prevailed in Ephesus. Like I said, if my platform, you don't like what I am doing, or you are not comfortable, you can please by yourself unfriend me, or you block me. Why? Because why? Maybe you don't want to hear the truth. So if you don't like what I am doing, you can be watching from far, or rather by yourself unfriend me, or you block me. No cause for alarm. But like I said, for as many that ask ears, you hear, you do what God have asked you to do. In fact, the Bible says, such a man or such a woman is not meant for condemnation. I am secured and I am safe in the hands of the Lord. I am safe, I am secured in the hands of the Lord. My life is not in the hands of any man. My life is not in the anybody. Thank you. Before the internet starts failing, I think I have to go. God bless you all. And as we go to bed, in the name of Jesus, the network is fluctuating already. Just as the mountains surround Jerusalem, may the Lord God of hosts continue to build an edge around each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. Wherever they will mention our name for evil, Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire upon them in the name of Jesus. Why? Because the Bible says, when they see the blood, they will pass over. May the Almighty God continue to watch over us, build an edge over us in the mighty name of Jesus. Our day is blessed. Our going out and our coming in is blessed, because it's already the dawning of another new day. It's already after one. Our day is blessed. Our going out and our coming in is blessed. Our food is blessed. Our bread is blessed. Everything about us is blessed. It is blessed and it is blessed and it is blessed forever. So like I said, let us not be afraid. Whether there is an affliction on the air, whatever is flying on air, let it begin to fly. The Bible says we will see, we will hear, but it will never come near our dwelling. Because why? He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow. So let's remain in Jesus. Keep staying in Jesus. Remain, stay in the name of the Lord of Jesus, and you are secured and you are protected in the name of Jesus. As I pray it for you, I pray it for myself and my household as well, in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you, beautiful men and women of God. Thank you, everyone, for always coming around to join me. God bless you all. And may God continue to strengthen each and every one of us. We will not run in vain. We will not run this race in vain. We will not work for God in vain. But we will work for Him. And at the end of it all, He will tell us, well done, good and faithful servant. This is my prayer for somebody. Mama Betty, God bless you, ma. Greetings to your household. And for as many that will come and watch later, Jesus loves you. Jesus is Lord. His word is here and amen. Let me leave us to go. God bless you all. Good morning to you all. By the special grace of God, hope to see you all again in our Father business. So, by next week, Wednesday. Stay blessed. Shalom. God bless you.